Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Thank you for joining us on this Thursday worldwide transmission. It is the 24th day of October, 2013, and we will open the phones up in this hour, the second hour, and the third hour. We have John Perkins, Confessions of an Economic Hitman, joining us to talk about the financial looting that is the global banking cartel's New World Order system and where it will lead us by design. That said, dealing with political correctness, there's a story up on drudgereport.com we're going to be talking about. University, Cowboys, Indians, and Sombreros offensive for Halloween. See, they're not only going to ban paper bags saying they're racist. They're not only going to say you can't call the Washington Redskins the Redskins. Once they get rid of things that you could argue could be offensive, they move on to everything else until only what's prescribed by the establishment is authorized. It's a total authoritarianism. And look, I know that you know this, but the point is they know this. These are not liberals. These are authoritarians. Now, if you want to forcibly inject Africans with shots that have sterilants in them, that's liberal. Because, you know, they're black folks and subhuman and need to be killed, according to them. That's liberal. See, so if you're Arnold Schwarzenegger who says you admire Hitler, you get ADL awards. But if you stand against the type of stuff Hitler promoted, then you're a racist. You understand? And there's no need to even show the proof. And by the way, it's not even meaning that you even buy into it and believe it. If you are an Asian group that wants to call themselves the Slants, a popular group who want to trademark that name, meaning a term from chords in music, and then I guess a pun as well, then the trademark office will refuse it. You no longer have free speech, and they're coming. Now, I looked into this last year and found out that, indeed, it is under the Obama umbrella with Michelle Obama, the food commissar, who says aspartame's good, GMO's good, non-organic's good, pure sugar's good, artificial sweetener's good, MSG good. No, everything that should be restricted in schools is forced in there. And feds order school to ban packed lunches without doctor's note. This is in Virginia, saying under orders from the federal program, they receive word from federal programs, preschool, pertaining to lunches from home. You must get a doctor's note saying it's a special diet. Again, it's just like vaccines. There's no law. You've got to take them. But they lie and says there is, say there is. And then they make you get a doctor's note, and the doctors are part of the crew now. They won't issue it. It's all about fraud. This is a criminal system where if you do what you're told, you keep the job in the system. If you don't, you're gone. And now that it's a government-run system, everybody's got to have a government or corporately government-controlled combine job. And so then they take over. I've got an article right here. 49% of Americans, it was 47 just a year ago, 49% of Americans now get government benefits. 82 million households on Medicaid. And that is the plan. They're going to get everybody but offshore banks above the law on the dole. But remember, Chicago schools first came out and said you can't pack your child to lunch. Parents can't be trusted. Parents are bad. They actually said parents, you know, don't make good choices. And then you look at the slop the school's pushing, it's another big corporate dumping ground of all the bad salt and all the bad MSG and all the bad aspartame and the chocolate milk, and then they're not allowed to run at recess because they might get hurt, and no dodgeball. I mean, this is a total prison. And heaven forbid you bring a water gun to school, you'll be arrested. Or now if you play with a water gun in the street, you're arrested. I mean, it's just, it's a total prison. And they've got juries will send you away for having a water gun on the street. I mean, it doesn't matter if no law was broken. They'll just still send you to jail because it's Pavlovian. They like the cop to pat him on the head and the judge and pack the biggest prison population in the country. And now all over the nation, they're telling them, you can't pack your child's lunch. They're going to eat GMO swill. But we've got bigger news coming up. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us on this Thursday worldwide transmission, the 24th day of October, 2013. I am your host, Alex Jones, and we are going to be here for the next 3 hours. John Perkins, best-selling author of Economic Hitman, or Confessions of an Economic Hitman, will be joining us to give us his take on the global banking cartels looting of the society and the police states they put in place once they take over the society to continue the bankruptcy and enslavement politically by design, just like a spider ties up its prey to take its time sucking it dry. That is exactly what's happening. We're going to be covering it. Let me just give you some of the headlines here. Here's Fox News. Does Army consider Christian's Tea Party a terror threat? And they put this out on Fox Insider instead of as an official Fox News article. The military's gone public from Fort Hood. Our listeners, I even know the unit, and said, we're being told Christians, period, are terrorists, and that do not give them money or we will be court-martialed. Now, see, this is economic warfare. Don't just have the IRS go after the Tea Parties. Don't just have them go after the pro-life groups. And don't just have the IRS caught lying to Congress and ordered by Obama to do it. I mean, that is totally illegal, totally oppressive, 100% authoritarianism. And Fox News won't even talk about it on their official Fox. They put it out to folks, to the libertarian audience they know is a lucrative wing. Because they already know, the libertarian audience already knows all this. So they'll put that out, but not actually put it on the news to really change stuff. They wanted to destroy Obama. They could do it with stuff like this. I mean, this is not just George Washington's bad in the new army manuals, and the founders are bad, and guns will be taken, and the military's on record now in the manuals being trained to take our guns and have a civil war. Our military has been captured, just like if the Russians had successfully infiltrated over 50 years, got all their people in, and then announced that gun owners and returning veterans and those that aren't part of the communist dream will be arrested. I mean, that's basically what this is. And you got Navy SEALs going public. You've got admirals going public. You've got colonels going public. You've got all these people. And it's always on Michael Savage's show or my show or drudgereport.com or Infowars.com. But no one else will report it, because if you admit it all, then you got to do something about it. And I was psychoanalyzing why I yell and scream and why I get angry, because I'm freaked out, folks. It'd be like if somebody was breaking in my door and I was tied up by the body politic and I needed the politics globally, but also domestically, the people to wake up collectively to then untie ourselves so we can do something while Freddy Krueger has got his arm through the window of the broken glass on the door, turning the doorknob right now. And we've historically watched Freddy Krueger butcher everybody on the block historically. In the last 100 years, the very same globalists funding the communists and fascists and authoritarians worldwide, from Indonesia to Nazi Germany, from Soviet Russia to communist Cuba. And we've watched it, and now they're to our door, and they're now in our living room, and I am tied up until we get the public awake. We're all collectively tied up, and we're kind of getting our arm out right now of one rope and could start untying ourselves, but now Krueger is walking towards us, laughing. And we got to get out of these ropes fast, folks. Fast. I mean, we are in mega danger, like a car rolling towards the edge of a cliff. We're 5 feet away. And yes, we've slowed the car down, but Freddy Krueger is behind the car, pushing it and telling us, don't worry, press on the accelerator. You know, he's waiting for us at the bottom. I mean, this is a nightmare scenario. And I've got literally 200 news articles here, each one more insane than the last. The U.S. is now known as a dumping ground for all forms of corruption and evil. China knows they can't ship poison food and medicine to Europe because Europe will sue them or shut down imports. They dump it. I have more articles today where they know that the regulators will let them dump any amount of poison, kidney failure, death, it doesn't matter. The FDA. While the FDA is shutting down basically any U.S. business that isn't globalist owned. I mean, if you're a major chicken producer that's on the globalist operation, you can have just rotten food. They just radiate it, spray viruses on it that eat the bacteria. Look that up if you think I'm kidding. They spray live vaccines basically on it. I mean, it's just a hell house. We are a hell house. And I just realized that my dad was listening yesterday, and he said, man, you got so dark. New listeners might, you know, think you're being serious, you know, when you're agreeing with the New World Order and that dark satire. Look, whatever. People need to hear what the globalists really think about you. And they pretty much tell you themselves, but I'll go all the way and, you know, play the part of the globalist here and their mindset towards you. But they don't just not care about hurting you and ripping you off. They enjoy it. And they've now got half the public on welfare, and they're soon going to have 60%, and they think it's game over. They think it's game over, and they're coming, folks. And I cannot stress to you how much trouble we're in. I cannot stress to you. I mean, the census data 2 years ago is now out. 49% of Americans get government benefits. 82 million households on Medicaid. They already get their health care paid for. And now they're going to loot all the working class people and middle class to just give trillions of dollars to offshore insurance companies who wrote this and then fine and fee all the working poor and drive them into bankruptcy where they've got to go on welfare, because then they're going to be told, now you got to go show up for compulsory national service to get your welfare. Now you got to take these shots to get your welfare. Now your kids are ours. This is it. This is the, you are seeing the real life collectivization of America. And people from the former Eastern Bloc are leaving the U.S. en masse. 40, 50, 60-year-old people that grew up under tyranny are crying at liberty rallies and freaking out and fleeing, crying, because they thought they could live and die in America and loved America because they've seen it. I mean, we are in red-level meltdown, okay? I mean, this is just... And I realize that's why I'm in so much mental anguish and why I get so nasty on the air, is because it's all true. It's all real. And Fox News comes out and says soldiers attending pre-deployment briefing at Fort Hood say they were told that evangelical Christians and members of the Tea Party were a threat to the nation, and that any soldier donating to those groups would be subjected to punishment under the Uniform Code of Military Justice. They would be court-martialed. Now, folks, you have to understand, they understand the mainline Tea Party is kind of like Republican Libertarian. The real Tea Party, started by Ron Paul, myself, and others 7-8 years ago, is anti-Federal Reserve, pro-America, pro-sovereignty, pro-Bill of Rights, pro-property rights, pro-liberty. And we told you in the internal training manuals that federal marshals, FBI, state police gave us around the country that broke nationally 5 years ago, that they say returning veterans are the number one enemy. Homeland Security is for them. Next, it's gun owners. And this is authoritarianism, folks. When they tell you now from Virginia to Florida, from Illinois to Colorado, that you can't pack your own child's lunch, that's back in the news today, you're living in an authoritarian state. When they get up on the news and have a creepy woman in a promo that airs every night of the week saying, your children belong to us, I mean, they know what they're doing. And you look at them, they're crazed. You look in their eyes, these are horrible demons, horrible authoritarians. They know they're not liberals. You understand? These are enemy soldiers, people. This is a military takeover. And they're now telling the military, just like Hitler did when he finally took over Germany, give me your loyalty, give me your litmus that you'll arrest, kill whoever we say. And the German and the Weimar military, over 90% of them stayed in. The 10% that didn't, they purged them later. Same thing in the Soviet Union. Lenin did the same deal. And they ended up purging folks anyways. It's going to be a lot worse if we don't resist this now. I'm here to tell you. And so we're in deep trouble. I mean, do you understand how illegal it is to tell soldiers in memos that have been given to us that the news has covered that are confirmed by the top general at Fort Hood saying you're not allowed to have guns as a soldier outside the base, even your own private ones? You're not allowed to have those. You're not allowed to demonstrate for the First Amendment when you're off duty. You know, but this is light years worse than that. Because the headline is, does the Army consider Christians' Tea Parties a terror threat? It goes on. You know, the headline should be treason. Troops taught that Christians are the enemy. I mean, just it wouldn't matter what group it was. I told you, Homeland Security was always to be flipped onto Christians, libertarians, returning veterans. And all over the country, we saw this a few months ago, in Colorado, they called in the state police, the captains of the state police, several hundred of them, in Colorado, the officers, and said, we're preparing for gun confiscation of radicals, including Christians. See, first they say it's for Al-Qaeda, then they say it's for gang insurrection, and then they segue to, no, it's for Christians. And by the way, they told the state police, this came out in the Denver newspapers, but they were like, oh, it's a good thing. Thank God the feds are teaching them this as part of their in-service training, that you're going to have to go house to house and we're going to take these people in. And listen, they're going to start a civil war. They're going to pick groups that, you know, are unsavory, white supremacist, others at first to set the precedent for this. And then they're going to roll out against everybody. And this is what they train 24/7 for. And then when the military reaches out, oh, let's tell Fox News, we've already told Alex about this, it just gets spun and stuck in the back of the paper. But at least it's there. You understand, if you don't stand against this, they are testing and asking the military, not the generals, that they've already are on board, or they're kicking them out with a litmus test. They've moved down to non-commissioned officers, which means they're getting ready to go operational to try to take our guns. I'm going to say this again. We have more than 20 official Army and military training manuals. We have the troops going public. I could open the phones up and have non-commissioned officers calling in, enlisted folks, telling you they're training to take the guns. I mean, it's in the news. I see it in local news stories in Texas, but also all over the country all the time, where they'll have locals at the school with the National Guard and the regular Army and the Marines, or all three, or local Air Force MPs, you name it, and they're training to go take people's guns. I mean, it's in the news all the time. Arcadia, Iowa, remember 4 years ago, they practiced going door-to-door to take the guns. And it was in the news that, well, they're training to take guns during an emergency in America. First place the Army hit with the colonel was the local gun shop that helped play along. Then they practiced going door-to-door to find the hidden guns in America. And then they freak out and go, conspiracy theorist Jones thinks it's for America, when I had the quotes from the article the day before. And the paper backtracked and said we were insane and none of it was real. See, because then there was a backlash. It was a PSYOP test in a town of 700 in Arcadia to see if they could announce gun confiscation in the paper. To see if in a small group, and of course later I learned from Army sources that indeed their PSYOPs was there. PSYOPs, by the way, didn't like what was going on, but they're all so scared they went along with the mission. You better be scared of following this mission. A mission to destroy your country? I mean, this isn't like losing some war in some questionable operation for the globalist. This is losing America. And you're just going to follow orders and do it, huh? I've got all this other news I'm going to get to, but I'd like to hear from the military. I'd like to hear from police, actually, because the military will call in and say they're not going to be part of it and they're being trained to do it and they don't like it. But I'd like to hear from the Fort Hood troops, who I know listen every day. I'd like to hear from folks all over the country, but police as well. Active duty and active police. Do I get an apology now? I don't want the apology. I don't even care. I just want you to listen. I want to save the country. They're teaching them that the Tea Party and evangelical Christians who believe in the second coming of Christ, that's Janet Reno on 60 Minutes, 1995, she said, if you believe in the second coming of Christ, you are in a cult and you are a terrorist. That's on record. If we could dig the clip up. And you're like, well, why are they coming after us? I'm just going to try to homeschool and live out in the woods. They're going to come get your kids. They're going to teach them. Jocelyn Elders said, don't you get it? These are perverts. They want control. And the number one thing they want is your kids. Just like in Sodom and Gomorrah, they wanted your kids. And just like in Nazi Germany, the state wanted the kids. And just like in Soviet Russia and Mao's Cuba and every other country, the statists want the kids. Don't you get it? They're coming for your kids. And they know you're going to try to work three jobs and live out in the countryside and try to have communities. And the Rural Affairs Commission under Department of Defense has now got Pentagon PSYOPs in every small town literally doing assessments on how to shut things down. And they're going to do it. I mean, the magnitude of this military attack. We are under total military attack. And now they've gone all the way down to the enlisted. That's the reason you're hearing about this. It was in the documents years ago, but oh, that's just a document. Oh, Alex says there's a civilian inmate labor camp program. Nobody'd go look up. It was public. Alex says there's Rex 84 and Garden Splicer and or Cable Splicer and Garden Plot. And Alex says there's this, National Emergency Centers Establishment Act. And Alex says, I didn't say any of it. It was all public. And I have my sources. We know their exact plans. We don't know how they'll try to implement them in what order. But, I mean, it is hellish. They're not just going to conquer us like they've done France with 100% taxes on the middle class. 100%. They're getting rid of them. The elite are all tax exempt, have Swiss bank accounts on record, including the socialist leaders. Because they're not socialist leaders. They're mafia criminals. Authoritarianism has scientifically come to America. They are gutting everything by design. And I want to hear from military. I want to hear from police. I can't believe police have to think about it, too, on the street and go, I don't want to take the guns, but if I'm ordered to, I'm not going to say. All because all you care about is your status and that uniform that now represents the New World Order, unless you stand and have that uniform represent liberty and justice. This is a big deal here, that now it's down to the grassroots military. It's down to the enlisted privates. They're being taught George Washington's bad, Christians are bad. I mean, they actually get them in there. And if you hang up on the bulletin board the oath, they pull it down. The officer walks in and tears it off the wall. I have FEMA on video saying the Constitution is terrorism and the Founding Fathers are bad. It's in my film Road to Tyranny, free online. And that was in 2001. Okay? These people are traitors. They're infiltrators. We've been captured. Can't you get it? Literally captured. You understand that? Literally. They are inbred psychopathic eugenicists. And they are the enemy of everything free, decent, and good. Bottom line. Fort Hood has now gone public and also responded in an unclassified release to their statements dealing with the veterans and how they're openly training to take on the American people. Let me go back to this article that I was just mentioning. Okay, continuing here with the news. Does Army consider Christians' Tea Party a terror threat? And then it begs the question because it goes on to say, soldiers attending a pre-deployment briefing at Fort Hood, where they were doing riot control and gun confiscation drills, I should add, that was in their local paper, said they were told that evangelical Christians and members of the Tea Party were a threat to the nation and that any soldier donating to those groups, this is violating their First Amendment. I mean, this is a trillion times worse than what Nixon did with a few hundred names of people off the IRS. They give all your info now to the TSA, folks. Everything's public to these criminals. Soldiers attending a pre-deployment briefing at Fort Hood say they were told that evangelical Christians and members of the Tea Party were a threat to the nation and that any soldier donating to those groups would be subjected to punishment under the Uniform Code of Military Justice. The October 17th briefing, a soldier attended, told the reporter that those attending the briefing, they told me that the counterintelligence agent in charge of the meeting, see, counterintelligence, dealing with the enemy, the American people, because it's a foreign officer, spent nearly a half hour discussing how evangelical Christians and groups like the American Family Association, just see, they really hate mainline groups like that, and Dobson, and they're really threatened by just really nice, friendly, mainline Christian groups that have, you know, little audiobooks for kids and things. It's so unbelievably evil. I mean, this is the Soviet takeover of America, but it's bankers using that technology of control. Michael Berry, an attorney with the Liberty Institute, is advising the soldier and has launched an investigation into the incident. The American public should be outraged the U.S. Army is teaching our troops that evangelical Christians and Tea Party members are enemies of America and that they can be punished for supporting or participating in those groups, said Barry, a former Marine Corps JAG officer. These statements about evangelicals being domestic enemies are a serious charge. It's not a charge. I love how the media always acts like they don't know, and then even the lawyer involved thinks it's just Fort Hood and just thinks it's his. It's everywhere on record. We have the training manuals. They're all on Infowars.com. It's all been covered by the news after we break it. Saying returning veterans are the number one enemy. Gun owners are number two. Christians are number three. Period. Libertarians. Mainline Republicans. Do you understand this? They are going to get more than 50% of the public on welfare. They're already at 49%, and they're going to have them vote to take everything. And the bankers are all exempt, so they don't care. So I want to hear from police, and I want to hear from military about this. You have a war on the press, a war on whistleblowers. You have incredible corruption going on. You have all these corrupt interests looting the country seven ways to Sunday. And the military, number one threat, not the communist Chinese, not the Russians, not Al-Qaeda. The number one job mission is now Homeland Command, NORTHCOM brigades in every sector, training 24-7 to kill people wearing overalls and John Deere hats. I've shown you the video. I've been to the urban warfare drills. The troops have called in and broke down crying and said, I heard you talk about this. I didn't believe it. We practice and they always start crying because it's not that they're scared or wimps. It's painful when they go out and train to kill somebody that looks like their granddaddy did. They're training to kill the rural people because they know they're the only ones when they take over that are going to be able to hold out and grow their own food. They're going to kill everybody. They are. You understand? They're going to bring in foreign troops, everything. I'm sure of it now. That's why they built the invasion routes out of Mexico down to the major ports where the Napa Superhighway has put the country in two with a Chi-Com operation. It's all real, folks. Everything military people told me 20 years ago I rolled my eyes at, and they said, no, that's the plan. It's all real. It's all been set up. It is unbelievable how much trouble we're in. And they will nuke U.S. cities. When they do it, NORAD will stand down. They will say patriots have done it. You watch. And the Chinese are here to help, and the average welfare head will sit there at sports stadiums while people like myself are being killed in firing squads, and they'll have it on national television with Rachel Maddow hosting it. I'm telling you, these people are the enemy, period. But hold your fire. They're trying to stir us up into real stuff because we always catch the provocateurs. People, the provocateurs, when I say this, they get really mad and all attack me, and you can tell these people are feds every time. Do not do anything. Do not. The more they abuse us, the more everybody sees it. They are just like Gandhi did civil disobedience and let them beat him up and stuff in front of people. Just continue to be Christ-like because there's a time to stand down. There's also a time to kill, a time to reap, a time to sow, a time to be born, a time to die. Will you guys print me that full Bible passage, please? I want to read that here on air. And the point is, my gut and my spirit says, take it. Just keep letting them hurt us. Keep letting them abuse us. Just keep doing it. Okay, and make them stage the big false flags, and the military's going to know. I've already diagrammed all their different possible battle plans, and they're going to lose. They will lose the invasion. We can beat the Chi-Coms. We can beat them. We can beat them. I'm telling you, it's not going to be Russia, folks. It's going to be the Chinese. To everything, there is a season and a time. To every purpose under the heaven. Ecclesiastes 3, a time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, a time to be plucked up, that which is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up. I like the King James much stronger, but a time to weep, a time to laugh, a time to mourn, a time to dance. A time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together. See, there's time to let them hurt you. There's time to stand up. Let's go back to it. A time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to get and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to cast away. A time to rend and a time to sow. A time to keep silence and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time of war and a time of peace. What profit hath he that worketh, that weareth in he laboreth? I hath seen the travail which God hath given to the sons of men to be exercised in it. He hath made everything beautiful in his time, also hath set the world in their heart, so that no man can find out of the work God maketh from the beginning to the end. I know that there is no good in them, but for a man to rejoice and to do good in his life, and also that every man should eat and drink and enjoy the good of his labor. It is the gift of God. No, you didn't build that. God didn't build that. It's the gift of the state. See, and we sit here. Print me the King James Version, please, of that. I want to read that later. Thank you. The issue here, ladies and gentlemen, is that we're at the crossroads, and everybody knows it. And they wouldn't be giving the orders down to the enlisted to get ready to take guns and arrest the Christians and kill those that resist and take their guns. I mean, these people are just abominations. And the false flag is also going to be economic collapse, where they pose as the saviors. And God help us, and God help all the fools in Congress that went along with this. When they roll this in, there's going to be a lot of scores settled. They're going to guarantee a whole bunch of Congress people are going to end up getting their throats slit by the establishment. This is going to make the red takeover in 1917, 1918, and the 10 years it took them to consolidate power over Russia look like a cakewalk. And I'm here to tell you, bowing down to this is what's going to allow the rivers of blood to flow. We can stop this right now, but we let them tell us that, hey, you can't pack your kids' school lunch, your kids belong to us, we're going to give you vaccines, even though there's no law. We're going to have checkpoints, even though it's illegal. We're going to leave the borders open. We're going to give the illegals all this free welfare to incentivize them coming here, but cut your welfare. It is so hellish what they've done. I mean, look at some. Let me give you the toll-free number for military and police to call in. 800-259-9231. 800-259-9231. You are not going to grovel to this and get out of it. It is exterminism. It is death. I'd use the fifth element analogy of the dark entity coming towards the earth to destroy everything. You don't make a deal with that. It comes to kill everything. And it's, of course, an allegory of Satan. You need to understand that, ladies and gentlemen. You cannot make a deal with this. You cannot reason with it. It's all a lie. You've got to realize this is the great coming of evil. And we can get a reprieve, but it's going to take everybody admitting how much trouble we're really in. They're now publicly going, well, maybe Christians are terrorists. And they're teaching the state police it everywhere. And they're teaching the military. And they're teaching them that they're going to take our guns. That's why police chiefs on tape now won't say they won't take the guns. When I was out there at that gun rally, they had feds standing behind and giving orders to the police chief of San Antonio. Because they're not feds. They are globalists. And they've been put in positions because they will carry out the orders. And they've been promised great power. All you're going to get is the same thing that others that serve evil get. You will be destroyed. But most importantly, you are honorless. You are pathetic. I want to hear from military. I want to hear from police currently. Are you too scared to even call in and say you will stand for liberty? 800-259-9231. 800-259-9231. And they're bringing in the tyranny because they have to. They want to break this country's back for once and for all. It makes Cloward and Piven look like a blessing, what they want to do here. It's more like breaking the back of Poland or Ukraine under Soviet occupation. In fact, it's pretty much the same battle plan. Except we're heavily armed, and we've known they were coming. We've been digging in. That's why they announce us as the enemy. The people that have occupied the country, the globalists, and their corporate interest, using Soviet model control, again, they're not Soviets. They're using Soviet model control. The Soviets worked for them before, the same big banks. They were able to bring them down. America was too strong. Now they've basically got us, they think. 800-259-9231. And then I've got this on Infowars.com. Feds order school to ban packed lunches without doctor's note. This is in the local news. Dear parents, I have received word from the federal program's preschool parenting to lunches from the home. Parents are to be informed that their students can only bring lunches from home if there is a medical condition meriting a specific diet, along with a physician's note to that regard. So your children belong to the state. You will pay money for their deadly GMO. And it includes ice cream and GMO nachos with MSG chips. I also am sorry for the inconvenience. If you have any questions concerning this matter, please contact the Stephanie blah blah, the health coordinator for federal preschools. You see, when they have the federal programs, if any money goes to that, if 10% of the kids in the school are on a school lunch program, now they control what everybody does. This is total domestication down to what your kids eat. We're already in mega tyranny. There's just old segments of the old republic still operating, but we're being overrun. We're under attack. You understand this? They're going to kill us when this comes down, and then they're going to come after you. We need help. This is not a game, people. The country's been overrun. And now I only realize how close we are to their operation going live. And I mean hot. Nukes going off. Shutting down the economy. Wiping out tens of thousands of Patriot leaders in a single day. Folks, you see communications go down? Death squads are coming. Be ready. Move. Move out of those areas. Get behind them. I'm telling you, this is, I cannot believe it's so hardcore. I cannot believe it's really happening. And I don't mean to get like that. It's just that as a man, I just sit here calmly while the TVs are on, the sports games go on, everybody's in this matrix trance while they're openly taking over society, training to arrest Christians en masse. You go to the big mega churches and the cops are watching you, you know, filing stuff. You ask the preacher, you clergy response. They get on a little power trip and go, I can't discuss that with you, my dear son. And it's like, you're not a preacher. You're a government operative who thinks they're James Bond. You're a traitor. You're not James Bond. You're a stinking commissar. And all these little candy. Oh, man, I tell you. Let's go to your phone calls. Charles in Arkansas, Sergeant National Guard, then Scott, who's Army, Michael in Kentucky, who's Army. I haven't even gotten to any of the other news yet. It's all insane, everything. I'm trying to be calm about this. It's just, are you being asked if you'll fire on U.S. citizens? Are you being prepared in your area?
I personally have not got that order yet.
Good. Have you heard from others that it's going on? Because it is confirmed in the news they're asking this.
Alex, I don't even know where to start. It just doesn't make any sense. Like, when I woke up about 6 months ago, it was my six-year anniversary for being in the military. And this whole time before then, I didn't even understand what was leading up to it. And, like, now I think back, and there's little pieces that start fitting together. Like, I'm in the desert doing desert training in California, and I'm going to the DFACT with people from Turkey and other countries. And, man, it's freaking me out, Alex. It's freaking me out, dude.
It's a global government army where they can invade anybody they want.
When I ran across your video for the first time, like, I think it was Endgame, and I seen it, my jaw dropped, and I believed every single bit of it because I'm an intelligent individual, and I can see what's happening and what's going on. And I've tried to wake up so many people. Every person I've seen, my Facebook got shut off, and people started calling me higher up than me in the military, and were telling me that I need to stop saying what I'm saying, right? Like, my
let me ask you this. What do you make of the Fox News thing? We already knew about this. It's part of the general training. FEMA's coming in, the counterintelligence operatives, and they're telling them their enemy's the people, and they're telling them you can't give money to a Christian group, a Tea Party group, or we'll court-martial you. I mean, they're openly saying you have no First Amendment. It's incredible.
First time I heard about anything religious-wise, I was told that we are not allowed to witness to people anymore to try to turn them to Jesus. And I'm a Pentecostal. When I said,
well, I'll tell you what, stay there. I'm going to come back to you and then to Scott, Michael, Jim, and Les. But this is why this is important. Only Christians can't do it. This is off-duty, by the way. Off duty, you're not allowed. Again, they don't have that authority, folks. And yeah, that was earlier last year. We're going to come right back and let you finish up with that, Charles, and hurriedly go to Scott, Michael, Jim, Les, and others. Stay with us. Paul Watson's got a more detailed article than Fox News out. Fort Hood soldiers told that Christians, Tea Partiers, and radical are a radical terror threat. But the issue there isn't even that. That's been going on for a long time, and it's total treason and totally illegal and domestic authoritarian takeover. The issue is that they're saying don't give money. Like, don't give money to Al-Qaeda or we'll arrest you under NDAA. They're saying we will arrest you if you give to evangelical groups. Evangelical groups are probably in the top two, maybe the biggest group in this country, after Catholics. I mean, that's like saying 60, 70 million people that identify themselves with evangelicals type stuff. Don't give them money. That's how you politically crush people, is you say, don't be part of this. Credit Swiss is coming out and launching gay-friendly company index, saying they'll do business with people that socially promote the gay lifestyle. And again, it's not like, oh, here's my bank. Everything is going to be leveraged money-wise to make you comply. It's authoritarianism. This is the takeover, folks. They've already got our kids. We put up with anything. We let them tell us that we can't bring sack lunches for our kids, that paper bags are racist. Why not? We do whatever they say. Of course they're telling, briefly, I want to go to your calls. Charles in Arkansas, real fast, this did come out in the news last year where they said, even off duty, you don't tell people about Jesus. Go ahead.
Yes, that's true. That's true. I got to tell you what started my awakening, though. Okay, 9 months before my 6-year anniversary in the military, I went on a mission, and it was to deliver vehicles to all the armories around Arkansas. The amount of armored vehicles that we were bringing, like, it kind of, you can't just see that and not think about there's something wrong here. And then we start getting turret kits. And I've been in for 6 years, and I have never seen heavy machine guns, that many. And then now I work on night vision goggles. We have night vision goggles for every single person in our unit. That's, we're a maintenance unit.
Yeah, like, for those that don't know, and this is what I was told by family along, this is like 8 years ago, they were in Austin at the airbase shifting to where even the maintenance people are training for not riot control, seek and destroy operations against the American people, and that's it. A domestic army with better equipment than frontline soldiers have got in Iraq for us. And Iraq was a laboratory, the Pentagon admitted in one document I saw, for America. This is all checkpoint insurgency Fallujah-style stuff. So, yes. Okay, so basically you're seeing it all built up with these arms caches, and those are in the news as well.
And then I was just telling family members, like, how weird it was. So I just went and searched conspiracies, and I started seeing your name pop up everywhere. So I was like, all right, man, I got to check this guy out, you know, YouTube it. And Endgame is the first thing that pops up. And like I said, drop my jaw. That's all I got to say.
Well, God bless you, sir. And just how many people in your units that you work with, how many of them now understand what's happening?
Oh, my God. The first time I ever heard it, like, anyone talk badly about the government was last drill, okay? And even larger sergeants, and every single person is talking about it, and it's the chatter. It's 80% of my unit.
Well, let's be clear. Let's be clear, though. This is not the government. Just like if a hijacker hijacks an airplane, and psychologically they do this, puts on the captain's uniform, because people submit then. Okay? I mean, it's like if you came home when you're 10 years old, and a guy's wearing your dad's work uniform and says, hi, son, I'm your dad. And your mom's hanging there and you're, you know, and all this stuff's going, you're like, you're not my dad. They're like, yes, I am your papa. This is not the government. We need to this is an infiltration. Well, God bless you. That's the best news I've heard. But let me tell you, they could really put on some theatrics, you know, a militia attacking a school, detonating a nuke with Al-Qaeda. You're like, that doesn't make sense. Militias don't like Al-Qaeda. The scripts are saying that. That's what they're prescripting. I'm telling you. I mean, folks, we're in a Mexican standoff with the New World Order, basically.
Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
What is a Mexican standoff? It's where one person's pointing a gun at somebody, the other person's pointing a gun at them. Then somebody else is pointing a gun at that person. What is being shanghaied? It's being knocked on the head on the West Coast and thrown on a ship and taken to be press-ganged in the Orient. But the political correct people don't want you knowing language, so they just say that's racist. Here's London Telegraph. Offensive Halloween costumes banned by U.S. university. You can't be a redneck, too. They've already said that's racist. Not to making fun of white folks is bad, but just wanting to be a redneck, rednecks are racist. Working in the countryside and being white and working is racist. And now University of Colorado Boulder tells students to avoid costumes including cowboys, Indians, white trash, or anything politically deemed offensive. That's right. Mind control. And brown paper bags are racist. No, they're not. It's about making you shut down and be scared to talk and learn and interface. It's authoritarianism. If you just joined us, Infowars.com is reporting, but so is Fox News. They are telling Army soldiers that if you give money to Christian groups, you will be court-martialed and arrested because evangelicals that believe in a second coming of Christ are terrorists. You cannot make this up. We're taking military and police calls. Who's been holding the longest now? That'd be Scott. Then I'm going to go to Jim and Daniel and Les, who's a police officer. And we're going to hold our guest that's coming up, John Perkins, till 20 after. We're going to go to him after we go to your calls. Scott in North Carolina says you're in the Army. What is your take on saying that Christians and Tea Party, period, are terrorists?
Well, that's flat-out ridiculous, obviously. Just to know, I'm out of the military, a few years separated. But when I was in, I didn't pick up on any of that sentiment. We had briefings regarding domestic-type terrorist threat or a political extremist type of organizations. I personally don't recall much of that. You know, it's just a total overstep and attack and pretty much a brainwashing attempt.
No, that's it. That's it, Scott. It's total authoritarianism. Thank you for calling in. God bless you. I want to talk to folks who specifically are in right now or police who are getting these briefings or have gotten similar things. When we know about the briefings, we have links. This is confirmed. But I want to hear what you think about this. I mean, it'd be like if aliens landed and said, we are your leaders. Anyone that doesn't want to be under, you know, our control is a traitor. I mean, it's that ridiculous. Les in Oklahoma, who's a police officer, what is your take on this, Les?
Oh, Alan.
Hey, buddy.
All right. What I want to make is that sometime back, police departments were able to get M16, full auto, Colt A1 M16s from the government for $78 a piece, and that was delivered for $78. Now, the full auto M16, to me, that is something that you really don't need unless you're going to be going against somebody else with full auto weapons. But I think that it's just part of them gearing up to put munitions in place for when something does happen.
That's right. No, it's on record. Under Brigade Homeland, they are putting in every sector and their different sizes depending on the geographic area and population. It's on record, sir. See, everything you've already reverse engineered is in documents. You can go look them up. They are caching the armored vehicles, the weapons, everything, so they can come get them when they need them and take them from you, and then have special federalized special event units that are going to be expanded that are really federal auxiliary, as you know.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I know that. But, you know, for $78 for a full auto M16, I'm not talking three-round burst. I'm talking full auto M16.
I tell you what, Les, stay there. Don't hang up. I'm going to come right back. Come right back to you. It's a short segment. I'm going to come back to you. Then we're going to talk to Michael, Jim, and Daniel. And then we're going to get our guest on about what the banks are doing to us. Look, they're openly saying the veterans are the number one terror threat, gun owners, and then Christians, and telling troops you'll be arrested and court-martialed if you give money to a Christian group. Headlines up on Infowars.com. Forded soldiers told that Christians, Tea Partiers, a radical terror threat. But more importantly, they've been told by the counter-terrorism, counter-insurgency federal officers that now command them under Homeland Security. Oh, that's now official. The new fifth column, literally, quite literally, officially Pentagon run now via Homeland Security, so they've merged the two, putting a former Pentagon official over it. Yeah, Johnson. His name's actually Jad Johnson. But you have all of this going on, and they tell him you will be court-martialed if you give money to any evangelical group or if you give money to any Tea Party group, which are legal, lawful groups, being harassed and persecuted by the IRS. That's why some of the top evangelicals and the Southern Baptists as well came out and said, turn your guns in this year. Because they've been told by the IRS. It's come out in Congress that they tell them, stop protesting abortion clinics and we won't seize your bank accounts or arrest you. And they go, but we're not doing anything wrong. We're a 501c3. We're a charity, a Christian charity against abortion. We're going to arrest you. And a lot of them go, okay, I guess I won't. And they go, good, victory. They want to shut down our political activities. This is so illegal. This is so evil. This is what we were brought up to learn about Russia and China and Cuba. And they're doing it. And we got a police officer, Les in Oklahoma, talking about how they're giving him M16s and weapons basically for nothing. Armored vehicles are being pre-deployed everywhere. Then we're going to go to Michael and Jim and Daniel. And then we've got John Perkins, Confessions of an Economic Hitman, joining us. Les, finish up any other points you want to make. And I'm sure you guys get your federal in-service training to get the free federal money that's not really free. I mean, it's in all those manuals that anybody that talks about a second coming of Christ is a radical. Ron Paul's a radical. A lot of them say Alex Jones is evil and a radical. We get those reports. Anybody that doesn't like the Federal Reserve is evil. Returning veterans are the number one enemy. I mean, have you been taught that in your department?
No, we haven't been taught that here in our department. And I will say, yet, anyway. And as far as people being radical or you being radical or whoever, anybody who's aware of the truth of what's going on, they're going to call radical. I know that for myself, if I am ordered to take guns from Christians, to take guns from anybody, I am one officer, and I know of many, many other officers who will throw their badge and commission cards on the desk and go home.
Well, that's a good thing to do. The problem is then down the road, as they shut the economy down, you get put on a list. So what do we do when the next phase comes and they come to throw you in a gulag with a bunch of communists, that's what they're going to use as their enforcers, literally torturing us to death? I mean, I'm not kidding. That's what they do everywhere else. That's what the weathermen that raised Obama planned. We have all the training, you know, films, all their plans that came out. I'm not kidding. If they could get away with it, that's their goal. So what do we do at that point?
Well, at that point, I know myself that I am not going to go to a gulag. I'm not going to go anywhere. I'm a free American, and I'm just not going to go. I will not lay down and say, okay, I'm going. No, that will not happen. And I know many, many other officers that they will not lay down and go.
Well, God bless you, sir, and I appreciate your call. And that's an honorable thing to say. So many police now won't even say that on record. And here's how it'll work, though. They'll say, oh, Sergeant, whatever his name is, Sergeant Jones or Sergeant Brown or Sergeant Wachowski or Sergeant Gonzalez, whatever the name is, he had child porn. He had illegal guns. He was selling them. He killed his wife, something like that. You'll know when you see it happening to a bunch of people, it's pure bull. I mean, just know that up front. Like all these generals they've been kicking out, we now have Navy SEAL sources, public and also off record, that have confirmed the Navy Admiral was given the litmus test for gun confiscation and other issues and was removed. And that we have another source saying that, yes, the word is on the other general. It had something to do with the missing nukes and a litmus test. That he was criticizing the chain of command above him and saying this is unconstitutional. And now you don't hear from those generals and admirals. I mean, they are just culling the military out right now. Because, I mean, I'm not even saying these generals are like angels or anything. The point is, though, it takes a lot to really gut a country and to really shine on to evil. I mean, when you shine on to the New World Order, I want to be clear. If we had boss hogs taking over who were just losing some stuff and being corrupt, I would criticize them. I would fight them. But I wouldn't be up on air freaking out. I mean, they don't like us. They want to extinguish us. Tyrants have always hated Americans because we've been free and rebellious and armed. They've got to have a world government with disarmed slaves. They got to take us down. They're not secure till they've done it. And they're using the communist Chinese and their 1,300,000,000 poor souls that are their slaves to leverage everybody out and as the muscle. And I've been told by high-level sources over and over again, there's a plan to bring in communist Chinese troops up from Mexico on the Baja side, when that big giant port they've got, the biggest in the world they're building, and to bring them up and call them stability troops as an I-4 mission of the UN. Now that's being discussed. And now the Chinese government can run what movies we have and control. And I used to hear that and think, you guys, this is some bait and switch where we got to worry about some outside enemy. And now I realize, I look at it all and go, my gosh, they really are planning that. And that's what the weathermen, raising Obama, it came out in federal documents, they admitted it. Graffwald heard them and they admitted in court that they were going to bring the communist Chinese in to middle America. They've had this plan forever. I just can't believe it. It's so crazy. And with a straight face, they go, you can't pack your kids' lunches. You can't see your kids at school. We're putting barbed wire fences up. Your kids belong to us. We're going to give them shots. All over the country, they give shots and they give the kids shots without asking the parents. Let's go to other calls. I'm just marveling. I'm sorry. Michael, in Kentucky, you're in the Army. What's your take on all this? And do you know anybody that's been given this training that Christians are the new enemy?
Former Army, and the reason why I'm not there anymore is because they did ask me that question. What I think about all of it is that, you know, as a non-commissioned officer, which we are the backbone of the military, I'd urge all NCOs listening to your program to remember what your oath is, and I am an oath keeper also, and you keep that squared away high and tight, and when this thing kicks off, we're going to win.
You know what I'm saddest about? Not only will we lose a lot of good patriots in this, the average cop and military person we're going to be fighting doesn't even know what they're part of. I really don't want to have to kill these people to defend my family, but I'll do whatever I have to once it starts.
But it's nobody wants to do that. Okay, but the initiation of the action is, once it's on, okay? And, you know, you take those snot-nosed kids that are police officers now and sheriffs who haven't got a clue that they're, you know, they're supposed to be there for the people. Well, when this kicks off, they're not going to be able to withstand the onslaught from the citizenry. Ex-military, people that are mad, there's weapons everywhere. They, you know, they're going to try it, but and it's going to get ugly. And you don't want to have to do that, but...
Well, look, I want to say this. I'm not even in a defensive, going to be offensive if they start it, because I'm obviously a political-type leader. But my issue is, I know they're going to come after me. I'm not going to just lay down to these people. And that's not bad. I mean, that's my right to stand up against the initiation of force.
You're exactly right. But, you know, the best defense is on the offense.
I know.
And you're on the offense with the program, everything that you guys are doing on the website. You're waking people up right and left, you know, every day. I'm out here on a pipeline right now, okay? And there's probably a crew of 90 out here. And as an inspector, I'm walking around talking to them. And, you know, 85% of these guys are awake. I'm seeing info wars out here inside of tool trailers. Okay? The best defense is an offense. And I would urge the public that has never been in the military, okay, I wouldn't get on the offense. Let former military and reservist and anybody that's got the right mind, let them get on the offense.
But then that's another question. Who do you get on the offense against? Obviously, it's the globalist operatives, the politicos that are going to be trying to command the military and police into the fight. Those are the people that think they're going to sit back in Tarrytown or wherever and call the shots. It isn't going to work that way.
Well, at the tip of the spear. Okay, and the tip of the spear is that idiot from any town USA that's willing to do their bidding. That's who we're after. That locks a lot of things up. And all of a sudden, the true believers in what they're doing aren't going to be true believers anymore.
They're not just shoving housewives around anymore. It's not fun anymore.
Yeah, it's all of a sudden it's real serious.
I just can't believe the communists with a bunch of crazy bankers are going to try this. I mean, they are nuts, man. I tell you, fortune favors the bold. They know that. Well, good talking to you. Interesting call from Kentucky. Michael knows what he's talking about. You know they're going to have a lot of trouble in Kentucky. They're going to use nerve gas, though. We got those documents via the Sunshine Project. Don't think this is going to be fun. Jim and others, we're going to get to you. We got a guest coming up. If you can hold, I'll get to you. We're going to have John Perkins on about 25 minutes. Then I'll go back to you if you can hold. If not, hang up. We'll be right back. Stay with us. They got America to basically give up its basic liberties and freedoms in the name of fighting Al-Qaeda, which they ran and controlled. That's all public now. Now they flipped it onto real libertarians and conservatives that are anti-war, pro-gun groups, property rights groups, and it's mainstream news today. It's up on Infowars.com that they're telling Christians you can't give to the Tea Party or evangelical groups or you'll be arrested and court-martialed. And that's totally illegal. You can't tell troops they can't do that. But this is the political persecution that Obama has been carrying out. But here's the thing. Nixon tried some of this stuff. Some of this stuff happened during Iran-Contra with Daddy Bush running it, wanting to test using COG to have a coup d'etat. This is happening throughout history. Always governments try to take over. Criminal elements in the governments. Just because this is all happening now, and it's happening at a level I've never seen before. So it is very dangerous. Doesn't mean we're going to have a civil war and all this stuff. We need peace, folks. I will do everything I can to not let them provocateur something or all the racial division, the rest of it. Now, John Perkins is an expert on this, and I won't go over his whole bio. He's with us till about 45 after, and I'll get back to your calls. JohnPerkins.org. He's a New York Times, what is it, number one best-selling author of Confessions of an Economic Hitman. He was a chief economist and advised the World Bank and the United Nations, and the U.S. Treasury Department, Fortune 500 corporations, and he's got a whole bunch of best-selling books on the subject, and they would send him in to try to get countries, third world, old world, to sign over their infrastructure and basically be financially robbed and enslaved, or he would then send in the jackals, who were basically folks that would overthrow the country. So the exact subject we're talking about here in America, it's the banksters that aren't free market, that are monopolistic, that do this, and you know, we see now in Obama the embodiment of Madison Avenue hype, where he's gotten away with things that Bush could never dream of. So it's not that Bush was good, it's that Obama is the more effective of evils. And John Perkins, in a nutshell for us, in a longer segment's coming up, seeing what's happening with the bank looting worldwide, seeing what's happening with Obamacare, not trying to give people actual health care, but just pay money to foreign, you know, insurance companies or whatever. I mean, as an expert on this, what do you think's really going on, and how can you tie your decades of running hitman operations economically into what you see? As a hitman, as an economic hitman, now making penance for what you've done, and I think doing a great job, what do you see as a mechanic? What do you see?
Hey, well, Alex, first of all, good to be with you again. You know, I think I go back to my old theme that it's really not the U.S. government that's behind this. It's the big corporations. And that's where we really have to look at our leverage points. How do we move the big corporations? Let's face it. Today, our president doesn't really have that much power. Our Congress doesn't have that much power. They're financed. Their campaigns are financed by the big corporations. And they become essentially servants to those corporations. And so if we really want to change things, that's where we have to look. And, you know, I'm not trying to let Obama off the hook or Bush or anybody else off the hook, except to say that the reality of the situation today is that we don't have a democracy. We don't have a representative democracy. You know, during most of my lifetime, I think it'd be fair to say that our elected officials wrote the laws, but they don't anymore, not the important laws. The important laws are written by corporate lobbyists, passed through the politicians whom they control. And that's what happened. So our democracy has really been robbed by a bunch of robber barons. And I think it's really, really important for us to understand that almost all of these issues that you're addressing, all very, very important issues, at some point in time, they go back to the corporations making huge windfall profits off us. The 1%, once again, exploiting the 99%. It's actually more like 0.0001% exploiting the 99.0, whatever, you know, 99.999%. So I think we really need to look at where these leverage points are, that in order to change government, we've got to understand that we've got to go after big corporations.
I agree with you. I talk about Obama because he's used as the diversion to carry all this out, and it's kind of like a closer at the end of a baseball game. And I agree that as we, whether it be on the real left or real right or libertarian, whatever, we're all targeted because we're independent and really trying to get justice. And these corporations are trying to convert us over to an authoritarian model that you saw carried out in the third world.
Exactly. You know, and in fact, we're meeting the definition of fascism when we go this route, or at least one of the definitions. There's many definitions, but that's one of them. It's interesting, Alex. I speak to some extremely conservative organizations around the world. I just came back from Southeast Asia, from Europe, from the Middle East, from Latin America. And I also speak to some extremely liberal, progressive organizations. It's really interesting to me how the two extremes, as well as what's in the center, invites me to talk. And one of the things that tells
me... Well, stay there. Come back and tell us about that. But I think that's what happens when you get down to survival. When you get right down to a crisis, people really start getting, hey, it's these mega banks, it's these big corporations that are bigger than most governments that literally are above the law and are establishing corporate world government. John Perkins, stay with us. When you have a world run by high-tech propagandists, themselves employed by ultra-rich, above-the-law, eugenics-based families, who are actively trying to dumb the population down in deindustrialized nations for political control. What do you do when they take over countries and literally destroy them and then exploit them? Well, now that's coming home to roost here in America. John Perkins, Confessions of an Economic Hitman, best-selling author, really blew the doors years ago wide open on a lot of the secret operations that go on. And so much of it, since he went public, has now been released, declassified, admitted. It's organized crime, ladies and gentlemen, that we're facing. And he went through his own realization. John, briefly, then I want you to get into what you were talking about, how we fix this, what you see happening worldwide right now, how you see an awakening. But just briefly, how did you begin to awaken? You've told that briefly before, but I think it's important to know that you know, you get into a system incrementally, all of a sudden you go from being a good guy to doing really bad things, but in the process of coming back to being good again, almost like Darth Vader, to use that analogy. And that's your story, is really the story of how we can probably even get those in the system to put the brakes on things. Take Joseph Stiglitz, you know, blowing the whistle as well.
Yeah, that's interesting, because two Nobel laureates, Stiglitz and Krugman, both have recently said that economics is not at all about what we're taught in economic school. It's not about supply and demand. It's all about being run by politics. Where they didn't quite go is to say, but politics is run by big corporations. So our whole economic system is run by big corporations. It has nothing to do with supply and demand. It could, but under the current laws and regulations, it does not. And I just want to I want to comment on what you said about it's run by organized crime. The big difference, Alex, is that unfortunately these guys aren't committing crimes. They write the laws.
That's right.
So they write laws that allow them to get away with what should be crimes. But in fact, for the most part, they're not breaking any
laws. I agree, but the Nazis put stuff on the books that they got hung for. Just because they have some, you know, 10 badges and write some stuff up doesn't mean it really doesn't break basic universal law.
No, you know, in fact, you think about organized crime, you think about the Prohibition, and what organized crime was doing at that point was actually something that soon became legal.
Sure.
So they weren't really doing anything all that bad in a way, although they were certainly killing people through all the mobs.
You're right. So I shouldn't compare organized crime to the bankers. That's insulting organized crime. You're right.
It is. It really is. The bankers are so much smarter than organized crime that they don't have to actually commit crimes. They don't go to jail. We all know they're not going to jail. They should be in jail. They're not going to jail. So anyway, you know, I realized after, as I went through this process of being an economic hitman, and I did that only for 10 years, and at the beginning I thought I was doing the right thing. You know, it's what's taught in business schools. But as I went through it, I saw that what I was doing was really criminal, even though it's legal criminality, and that what I was doing was just helping that notorious, infamous 1%, which is actually a lot less than 1%, get richer and richer and making the rest of us poorer and poorer. Destroying the middle class, in fact. And, you know, I think one of the things we have to do is to let the corporations know that we're just not going to buy from them as long as they keep supporting these draconian fascistic policies. We do have control. The marketplace is a voting booth. The marketplace is a democracy if we will just look at it that way and use it that way and put pressure on these people. And, I think this is so important. And to have the discussion that we're having now is a very, very viable way of making this happen. We have to put pressure on these corporations. And I think we have to recognize that in the past you needed a gun in order to take out a president. Kennedy, you know, everybody knew Kennedy was having affairs with lots of amazing women, Marilyn Monroe and Angie Dickinson and interns in the White House and so on. It didn't matter. But by the time Clinton came along, you know, they could impeach a president for a sex scandal. And then the head of the IMF was taken out for the same reason. He had an obvious weakness and they found it. I think we know today that Obama or McCain or anybody else can be taken down by a sex scandal or a drug scandal or an embezzlement scandal. And it doesn't even have to be true. It could be, you know, the FBI could create this very easily and send out a message to the mainstream media. You can destroy a president. You can destroy a senator. And I think they're all aware of this. So it's very important for us to realize that we, the people, have to take control. We are the ones with the power. Our leaders don't have that kind of power.
That's right. They're such puppets. The NSA takes the data, gives it to select corporations in these files to then blackmail people. Hey, you cheated on your wife 10 years ago. Do you want her to know about that, Justice? Fine, give us the vote we want. Hey, police chief, we know about you being in a unit 20 years ago that took some drug money. We know you're not really corrupt, but still you're going to go to jail for it. I mean, that's why they use these databases on record. That's why all this spying and stuff is so bad, because it creates a panopticonic system that really gives a power to the corporate tyrants that nobody's ever had before.
Yeah, exactly. You know, we're hearing about how the NSA spying now is impacting our relationships with Germany and lots of other countries, Brazil, lots of countries. But what we're not hearing very much about is how this can be used against the 16-year-old kid today who, in a couple of decades decides he wants to run for Senate or president or be police chief, as you said. And somebody goes back into his files and sees that when he was 14 or 15 or 16 or something, he sent a naked picture of himself or said something that for an adult would be inappropriate. But for a teenager might just be, you know, going along with the system. He has some girl to be his friend without benefit. Who knows? The fact of the matter is, what we haven't been discussing very much, and I wish we would, is how all of these files on young people today can be used against them in the future. Not necessarily to keep them out of office, maybe even to help them get in office, but once they're in office, to have complete control over them. Okay, now you're senator, now you're president. We got you. If you want to maintain your job, if you want to keep your marriage, if you want to keep your life, then you better play our game or we're going to expose something you did back when you were 16 years old.
What is the end game? I mean, I think it comes down to, for us, if somebody's doing good for the people and what's common sense, don't listen to the scandals that are so obvious anymore with just made-up tripe. The real crime is the big organized syndicate. But A, I want to ask what our end game should be, but B, what is the big corporate hedge fund, Goldman Sachs, J.P. Morgan Chase, what is their end game? Because I see the things they're doing. It's so authoritarian. It's so draconian. It's so anti-free speech. It's so anti-journalism. And I just don't know why these guys think that they're going to get out of building a bear trap like this. History shows the tyranny they're creating and the end of due process they're creating and of separation of powers and balance of power is a black hole that is going to destroy them as well. There's no way they're going to get out of this.
I agree with you, Alex, but I don't think they believe that. And, of course, a lot of them will get out of it, already have gotten out of it. As individuals, they retire with their golden parachutes and whatever. In the long run, the system's going to collapse. It has to. But in the short run, a lot of people in the process get very powerful and make a lot of money. What drives them? You know, I don't know. What drives a quarterback in a football game when he's way ahead to want to score one more touchdown, you know? I mean, it seems to be part of human character in a way to want more and more and more. But beyond that, the measuring stick for these corporate executives is money and power. And so if you work for Goldman Sachs and last year you only made $15 million, but the guy at the next desk over made $18 million. You want to beat him this next year. The two of you have this rivalry going.
That's right. You're not thinking about two or three steps down what you're doing, what it's causing. You're literally just had three wives, and one of them just took $10 million you had in the bank, and you want to make $20 million more.
Exactly. And you get together for beers after work or whatever. You know, you have to play these games where they talk about, hey, how many did you sell today? How much money did you make today? Blah, 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 blah. So to hell with the consumer. To hell with the public. You know, just keep building up, winning, scoring that next touchdown. It's just becomes part of our system. And I think what you know, your message is, what all of the message all of us has to be is that we got to create something better. Listen, we have created an abject failed global economy. You know, there's no question about it. It can't go on like
that. Well, that was my next question. You're a smart guy. Most of the experts we talk to say the prognosis goes from bad to worse economically. Where would you put the world economy? What do you expect to happen with this QE Unlimited? All the things we see happening here, I know you've written about seeing it on a smaller model in the old and first world.
You know, they can keep building it back up in the short term. Stocks go up. It looks like the economy is growing. And yet the middle class is still worse off every day. More foreclosures, high unemployment. The statistics that show that we're gaining are really statistics that show that the very wealthy are gaining. And the economic statistics in our country are very skewed to the very, very wealthy, that 1% that controls so much of the resources. So we really need to go into this and look deeply and say, hey, the job of corporations who control the world is to serve a public interest, not to serve that 1%. And we have this control. You know, you reach so many people, and you reach consumers. Women are the big consumers. You know, they buy a lot of things. Consumer groups that will go out there and say to these corporations, hey, cut it out. We're only going to buy from the ones that are going to serve our interests. Yes, make a decent rate of return for your investors, because that's how we develop better systems. And let's face it, we need a lot of better systems. We need to move into an economy that's based on cleaning up pollution, and creating better systems for transportation, communications, energy, banking. We, you know, let's get rid of that banking system and get into a new one. Better systems for treating sick people, all kinds of things. You know, we can create a better economy, but we, the people, have to be the ones to make that work, because our leaders just are not going to do it. And even if they want to do it, they can't do it. They don't have that kind of power.
I agree with you. So it's when the unmovable object comes into contact with the unstoppable force, they're going to try to start wars historically, false flags, stage right. terror, let terrorists attack us, to bring in the fear, to pose as our saviors. They're openly cashing heavy weapons everywhere, and openly now, down to the level of enlisted, telling them the new enemy is the American people, prepare for all this stuff. I mean, this is craziness. And then I see John Corzine making 40-to-1 bets with other people's money and not getting in trouble. I mean, I really think, just like Hitler and other crazy kleptocrats, I think these guys just think they're invincible. And I think they're going to probably, I think there's a good chance they're going to start World War III or something. I think they're that nuts.
Yeah, you know, you talked about letting the terrorists attack us. But what about, you know, encouraging the terrorists to attack us? You know, this, what's going on in Syria, I think is very disturbing, that in fact we seem to be in a position where we're going to be arming and supporting Al-Qaeda. I don't like Assad at all. I don't like the Syrian regime, but I don't think the answer is to you know, basically arm the enemy and support the enemy.
Well, exactly. Let me ask you this in closing, and then talk about your website and your latest book, and then we'll let you get going. I appreciate your time. John, I've studied history. I haven't been around that long. You know, I'm just 40 years old. But I've studied a lot of history, and I've been on the air 18 years. I've seen a lot of things happen. The elites now seem more reckless and more wild and more crazy than they've ever been. And I just see it on thousands of different points, like DU. They wouldn't let them use DU 25 years ago. Then they started letting them use it. Now they use it at local shooting ranges. I mean, it's a death sentence to whoever uses it on record. It's just on thousands of points. Used to, they didn't let reactors, you know, have 91% of the reactors publicly leaking worldwide, and the U.S. is the worst. I mean, it seems like there really is Max Keiser calls them suicide bankers or suicide stockbrokers, where the guy knew he was probably going to die in the towers, but he stayed at the terminal to make, you know, $20 million extra. I mean, it's pathological. They are mentally ill, I really think.
Yeah. You know, Max, I traveled around Ireland and part of England for a while with Max a little over a year ago. What an amazing guy. Yeah, you know, I think they're desperate. I think to a certain degree what's going on is that they're understanding that we're digging in. And I think we should take energy from that. It's kind of like Aikido. You know, when your opponent exerts a lot of energy against you, you turn it back around. So I think part of what's happening now is that they're beginning to understand that between the Tea Party and the Occupy movement, the extreme right, the extreme left, they're all incredibly dissatisfied. And everybody in the middle is dissatisfied. Oh, some of the people in the middle are just lethargic. But I think the status quo, I think what I call the corporatocracy, is understanding that they're in a desperate situation. So they're trying to rape us of everything they can in the short run, make as much as they possibly can in the short run, and also dig in.
That is very profound, because when I'm in a quiet place, you know, not on air and really thinking, it isn't confidence we're seeing. I agree with you. This is kind of a mad looting towards the end. And also have talked to a lot of elitists themselves that have apologized off record. They were running 5 years ago saying it was all over. And if you look, they're all running to the middle of nowhere with, you know, armed guards and stuff. I mean, I think you're right. I think they know they're not going to get away with this.
I agree. So we should get energy from this, and we should take great hope in this, and just keep up our struggle. Just renew it, reinvigorate it, keep talking, keep going around the air, keep doing what you're doing, Alex. And again, you know, I think we have to recognize that the right and the left are partners in this, and how do we come together in a way that will really make all of us force change
sure.
here?
Let me ask you this final question, and then talk about your new book. What do you think Obamacare really is? I mean, there's no way they put out something that doesn't work this bad and doubles the rates written by the insurance companies. I mean, I would prefer over this actually having, you know, like Northern European socialism and actually taking care of people that need health care. But, of course, that's not what it is. It's the same hedge funds that own the insurance companies, from what I've seen, stealing everybody's money.
I got to tell you, I've been traveling internationally for the last 6 months, and I'm not up to date on it at all. I don't feel very comfortable commenting on it. But obviously, we need something in this country. So many people go without insurance. I don't know what the right answer is, to be honest with you, Alex.
No, but see how they use the crisis of an already corrupt healthcare system to make it even worse?
Yeah. You know, that's not my thing. My thing is, let's go after the corporations on so many levels. Healthcare is just one of them, and it's one that I'm not terribly familiar with.
Sure. Plug the new book. Tell us about the new book.
Hoodwinked. Hoodwinked. You can go out to my website, johnperkins.org, and learn more about it. Please join my newsletter at johnperkins.org or dreamchange.org. I send a newsletter out once a month and a blog about once a month dealing with these topics. And I'm traveling around speaking. I'd love to meet some of your listeners and viewers face-to-face. So go to my site, see where I'm speaking, come up and introduce yourselves to me. I look forward to meeting
all right, John. Thank you so much for the time and your perspective. God bless. There goes John Perkins. Thank you, sir. We're going to go to break and come back with your phone calls. Folks that have been holding. Jim, I promise I'm going right to you. Department of Defense, civilian. William in Tennessee is a police officer. But first, we're going to go to Jim. And in the order they called, Daniel in Minnesota's Army. Then William is police. Jason is Army and police. I'm going to go quickly. I'll try to shut up. Just make your point. I'll go to the next person. When we come back on the other side of this quick break, please stay with us. Fox News is now reporting that opt-out Obamacare penalty can't be enforced unless you get a tax refund. And I don't care what the law says. The IRS doesn't follow a law. They're going to take the money out of your bank account as well. But Fox News is now reporting that. That's up on drudgereport.com, up on Infowars.com. Fort Hood soldiers told that Christians, Tea Partiers are a radical terror threat and you're not allowed to give money to them, violating their First Amendment. I mean, that is beyond authoritarianism. Healthcare.gov, Team Obama and its dysfunctional 500 million lines of code. Kurt Nemo has an article. BRICS countries build new internet to avoid NSA spying. Shock, cop buy shoplifter groceries. Feds order school to ban packed lunches without doctor's note. That is such a big story up on Infowars.com. It's expanding nationwide. It is a federal order. I told you that 2 years ago in Chicago and then in Denver. It is a federal order. individual, that's the news, confirmed. The schools are saying you must eat the GMO, your mommy and daddy can't pack you food. Think of the message to the kids. I mean, in the Soviet Union, they let parents pack lunches. I mean, whoa, nobody. In North Korea, they, I mean, this is unbelievable. I'm ranting. Let's go to Jim. Then we're going to go to Daniel. Everybody else, these are former military police, or no, current military police, Department of Defense civilian. What do you think of being told, or have you been told, have you heard about this, this new thing of don't give money to any mainline libertarian or Republican group or we'll arrest you, and don't give money to a Christian group or we'll arrest you? What do you make of that?
Well, I make out of it that they're attacking patriots, and specifically they're trying to undermine fathers. There, any sense of alpha male in the house or in the community, they want to tear it out because they want to prey on the women and children specifically.
That's right. They're now going to make Marines wear women's hats.
Yes.
I mean, these are a bunch of perverts. I'm sorry. Go ahead. Yeah.
They humiliate us out here. I'm in Los Angeles. My son, he goes to school in Culver City. He's 8 years old. And I had a principal actually tell me there at the school that government is the best thing to slice bread to raise our children. And I had to debate him on that and tell him that, you know what, as an educator, you should be ashamed to even say something like that, because the Constitution should have been in your curriculum at some standpoint during your tenure. And at this stage, we're sending out an SOS here from Los Angeles, because we need patriots here. We need more people who stand on the Constitution. This guy interrogated my son about the firearms that we have in our home. And he then called the police, Culver City PD. They followed up with CPS. CPS actually came out and said that the allegations were laughable. They said that I was neglecting my children because I own firearms.
I know. Doctors call the CPS. And again, they're not liberals. They're authoritarians. And there's no law. There's no nothing. They send CPS, and you're blessed you didn't get a bad one, because about half of them are really bad, and they try to take your kids when you own legal guns. I mean, California is how the whole country's going to be, my friend.
You have to rescind your consent. That was the first thing I said to him over the phone. I said, I rescind my consent. I don't give you any consent to come here or do anything. And the lady, these people speak a certain verbiage and a certain legalese that you have to stand up to them. If you don't, they're going to roll over you. They're going to do what they want to, and they're coming for our kids. They're predators out there. These people are predators, and there's a system.
I know.
The child support system, the welfare system, the family courts, the schools, they're all in cahoots. They all work together.
Oh, no, when you go to have a baby, and they sit there and go and kick the dad out of the room, go out of the room, please, sir, and they go, "Is you got enough money? Is he treating you nice?" And the wife doesn't know. They're putting you in a database. If she says, "No, we don't have any money, but his mom's helping us out," or whatever, they take your kids.
The doctors, they're in there as well. They're taking in as much information as possible. Don't tell them anything. Spin them around. Tell them, control your PR. Tell them what you want to tell them.
So that's right. That's right. Anything connected to the government or big corporations is the enemy. Folks, I'm not kidding. This is a scientific enemy we're fighting. We've got to oppose them everywhere. We're going to come back with Daniel and others. Jason, Leslie, William, stay there. Back in 60 seconds. Infowars.com, Infowarsstore.com. We need your support, your war bonds. We need you to buy the great products.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
GrudgeReport.com is linking to Limbaugh and his breakdown of it, but it's Fox Business. Fox Business went and did an investigation. Notice you've heard it here about 100 times. They're going to take all these poor fools that went and signed up at Obamacare. They're going to take their tax refunds, and they're going to hit your bank accounts. I shouldn't laugh. My dad says he listens to the show every day, and he wishes I would stop laughing. He says he knows I'm doing it because it's like hurting me, so I have to laugh and make a sick joke out of it. But at the same time, I mean, these people want to be hurt. I mean, they're going to wreck my family and my future as well, so I guess they deserve it. All these Obama supporters, so stupid. Let me shut up and go back to the police and military calling in. If you just joined us, it's official. Fort Hood and other bases are saying don't give money to the Tea Party or any evangelicals. They're terror groups, and that you'll be arrested for funding terrorists. They won't be arrested for shipping guns and weapons to Al-Qaeda or training them, but if you give money to a mainline evangelical church with 10,000 members, you're going to be court-martialed. Let's go ahead and talk to Daniel in Minnesota, who's Army. Thanks for holding. You're on the air. Go ahead. What's your take on all this?
Hey, Alex. Last month we didn't go in. I'm a reservist. I also do line haul truck driving. But we didn't go in last month, so I haven't gotten a briefing like that yet. But what I did get about September of last year, September 1st, in fact, I had just graduated from the truck driving school, and they told me I had to be on a conference call. I said, look, man, I got 200 some odd miles to get home. Do I have to have it? My sergeant told me, he said, look, it is a Homeland Security call. You will be on it, period. So I'm going down the road. I'm listening to everything that they're saying. They stood up a Seaburn team, Alex. Our entire mission was, our area of operation is everything west of the Mississippi. And what Seaburn is a chemical, nuclear, you know, weapons and stuff like that. We were to respond to that and any of the, national, you know, like these big, natural disasters and stuff.
Sure. And I want to be clear, because I've been following this 18 years, that's the EOD mission and the NBC mission is always the cover. And then once you get to the briefings, we have video of them, then it shifts to domestic extremists, and that's the real mission. But go ahead.
Yeah, see, that's what, you know, that's always in the back of your mind. And I'm hoping to God that that's not what this is. But, I mean, me and a couple of my buddies at my unit, you know, we're listeners. We know my platoon sergeant is, you know, he knows what's going on and stuff. He's the biggest security threat to the United States military. Let me tell you, information goes out, he processes it, and it goes right back out, you know? So he's been biting his tongue when I talk about it. And, you know, we started looking at all the guys that are on this mission because we got attached to a different unit. Alex, I mean, we're talking about combat arms, you know, tankers, scouts, infantry, all old, you know, that's their previous.
But MLS, see, you just said it. I told you. It's not NBC going out and washing people off. That's always the PR to acclimate the public to the military. Exactly. No, that's the cover of the mission. You're saying these are combat groups being prepared.
Basically. Well, that was our previous jobs. Our new jobs are like, you know, 88 mics and dealing with chemical stuff. But, you know, almost everybody is, like, their new job is truck driving. But their old stuff was combat arms. And, you know, my dad's been asking me, Alex, and he's been asking me, because I was one of the many soldiers that actually disarmed Sadr City, Iraq. You know, I mean, we went house to house and took.
Hold on, I want to hear this. So finish it on the other side. Give us 1 minute. Then I promise we'll go to Jason. Then we'll go to William, Leslie, Truth Raider, and others. I'm Alex Jones. Ladies and gentlemen, they are converting the military into an army to attack Christians and gun owners. Fox Business is reporting. We're going to get it linked up on Infowars.com. DrudgeReport.com has it right now. How will Obamacare's uninsured penalty work? And then it goes on to say they're going to take your refund, which they've always done to make you get the idea that the IRS is actually giving you a check, even though on average you get back a lot less than you pay in. They just want to set the precedent that they control your check. It's all about, I mean, hardly any other country takes the money from you first. You pay it after. We're such slaves because we think we're so free. What's the Bible verse? None are so enslaved as those that think they are free. Let's go to Daniel in Minnesota, whose army is in the National Guard, and he's seeing the reorganization of everything that's happening. And when you say the guys you know are awake, I mean, what's been waking them up?
You know, I honestly don't know, Alex. I mean, these are all guys, a lot of the guys that are awake, they're actually, sadly to say, are ex-Navy, but they're some of the best NCOs I've ever had. You know, it's just stuff that they've seen in the past, it's stuff that they're seeing now, and it's the, you know, they can count 1 + 1 = 2. You know, they're seeing the bigger picture. They're not watching, you know, just this or that. But, you know, it's just, it's one of those things, you know, for each everybody, it's something different. And when you take a group like what we've been set up for, and you put it all together and put us under Homeland Security, and, you know, as soon as this happened was the was it the hurricane out on the East Coast? We didn't get no calls for that. You know, since then we've had tornadoes up in Oklahoma, you know, not too far where we are. Because
that's right. Your new mission is preparing for combat against the American people, and that's on record. You're now under Homeland Security, and they put a Department of Defense guy over that, and it's this new fifth branch that answers to El Jefe, whoever the president happens to be. It is a classic takeover strategy. And it may not happen under Obama. It might happen in 10 years under some new president. But the point is, I've never seen the orders going as low as the privates. I mean, just 10 years ago or 4 or 5 years ago even, this type of stuff was being tested with generals. It wasn't going into lower-level officers or even non-commissioned. It's going all the way. But finish your point about disarming people in Iraq, because I remember reading several Pentagon documents and even a MIT report calling Iraq a laboratory for domestic operations in civil unrest, gun confiscation, and even Army Times has reported on what they call Brigade Homeland and that mission. So again, what people are hearing for the first time, if you just tuned in, all this is mainline documents. We shot a special report last night. I'll give people the name of it in a moment, and I'm going to tweet out to folks. But tell us about gun confiscation, what's that, how that happens, what that is like.
We actually ran a 16-man platoon because we was armor. So that puts about maybe, I'd say at most, maybe 10 of our guys on the ground. And at, you know, either evenings or nights, depending on our shift, Alex, we'd go, I mean, house to house down a block, kicking in doors. Or, you know, sometimes it was just as nice as, you know, knocking on it and saying, you know, Shaku Maku Habibi. And we'd go in and talk to them. And while our lieutenant sitting there talking to them, we'd be searching the house. And whenever we found weapons, we'd just take them. I mean, we and the people there was, you know, stupid enough, we'd, you know, take a, you know, fake computer or something and be like, hey, this is telling us that there's a weapon here. Where is it? And they'd hand it to us, you know? But it's not always, you know, the aggression. But when we hit something with aggression, Alex, you couldn't stop us. We had our infantry hit a house 2 times trying to pick up a high-valued target. They couldn't do it. When we went in and 10 men, actually it was less than that. I think it was 6 men on the ground that night. We hit that house so hard that my sergeant, he kicked the door. It actually came off the hinges. And this wasn't, you know, no light, you know, door. It was a heavy door. He kicked it off the hinges, went in there, and we was literally walking over top of people, ran upstairs, grabbed the dude before he could get out of his bed, and chunked him down the stairs. You know, it's a force that you can't really stop.
Unless you fortified your doors, and absolutely. But once a shooting war starts, people are not going to sit in their house and wait, as you know. And, of course, most of the Iraqis, from what I've read, tell me if I'm right, were not using their guns to actually attack forces that had invaded their country. They were using it for self-defense. They had their own Second Amendment.
Oh, yeah. I mean, that's basically what it is. And, I mean, they can get AK-47 there, you know, cheaper than some of their food sometimes. You know, cheaper than their medicine. They're so abundant. We used to take them that are nickel-plated, silver-plated with ivory and stuff on them. It was, you know, just truly amazing. But, I mean, that's the thing. We have to stand together. And I was talking to apparently a mutual person of ours, and I wanted to ask you about him off-air.
A mutual person. All right. Well,
yes.
You're piped into the Minnesota phone system. And then they pipe it through to me. I just do that so I have backups and satellite uplinks. So I'll put you on hold, and you can relay the question at the break to John Harmon, and then I can talk to you that way. So I'll put you on hold, Daniel, and come back to you off air. Just, John, get the question, and I'll relay it to you and then over to him. I don't want to, like, pipe it through the system because sometimes that can go on the air, like one chance out of 1,000. I want to go back to the phone calls. There's some breaking news. Will Obamacare grab your paycheck? Will it grab your bank account? Will Obamacare grab your tax refund? You bet they will, and that's how they're planning to do it. They say there's a fine, but they won't tell you how they're going to get it. Well, it's actually in the law. And that report is up at drudgereport.com. We're linking to it up on Infowars.com right now. We keep telling you that's in the law. That's how this works. Now, there is a report up on the website that I'm also going to tweet out where we broke down last night in detail in a 15-minute report, emergency alert soldiers warn of coming gun confiscation. And I'm going to have this reposted to Infowars.com because it scrolled off the front page. And I'm going to tweet it out during the break to Real Alex Jones, because we've put these reports out before and they've gotten almost 3 million views, which is great because it's not our regular 3 million listeners a day. It's new people that end up seeing this. It's military that end up seeing this. And then they get all the intelligence. They'll see the Emergency Centers Establishment Act on the video. They'll see the civilian inmate labor camp program. They'll see Forbes magazine and AP admitting the military brass is being prepared for gun confiscation so that it won't happen. They want to be able to get it all ready, line it up, stage some big event, and then roll it out. We got to blow them up before their rocket gets off the ground. I mean, that's what we do here, is we try to stop a civil war. We try to stop bloodshed. I got a wife and three kids. I don't want looking for this. I think we can fix things peacefully. We're starting to win in the info war, and they know that, and they're going to start something big, folks. That's what I'm trying to get across to you, the criminal interest that'll make money off a civil war in a wrecked country. And please, to the police out there especially, you, a lot of you have been handpicked now because you're imperious and, you know, you're very arrogant. It's very saddening. It doesn't humiliate me when I see police being rude and mean to people. It doesn't make me feel little, like, oh, I'm being dominated. It makes me sad for your ancestors and who you are. And also, if you guys continue where this is leading, I mean, it's leading somewhere really, really bad. So I'm going to tell you again, mister, I'm not looking for a fight. And we're not looking for a fight, mister, but you better stop. Because the higher-ups are offshore. They think they're safe. They know full well what's going to happen if this goes down. And I know most police I talk to on the street are actually nice and say they're awake. But then I run into cops constantly acting just wild. And I get getting jacked up even on my own show, you know, doing a job. It's easier to get the job done if you get jacked up. But it's this whole attitude that you train like we're the enemy and we're the threat. Tyranny is the threat. And they treat some housewife like, you know, they do some guy with, like, prison tattoos on them. And I'm done. I'm tired of it. I haven't done anything wrong. I'm tired of being treated like I'm evil. Let's go to Jason in Missouri, who's Army and police. Thank you for calling in and holding. Sir, you're on the air.
How are you doing today, Alex?
I'm doing all right. What is your take on all the stuff you've heard?
Well, I have 5 points that even if you got to hold me over, you've got to hear. I've got to get this out. I'm calling from mid-Missouri. I am prior Army. I was honorably discharged. In 95, our unit, and I was in a medical unit, we received an involuntary survey form from our platoon sergeant. You could not leave the facility with it. Matter of fact, you couldn't even leave the gymnasium with it. It was yes or no question. To keep in mind, 95, 96 at the latest. The questions were as follows. The ones that I remember, would you fire upon American citizens armed? Would you fire upon American citizens unarmed? Would you quarantine American cities in times of national emergency? So this was 95, and they were on a yellow card, the equivalent of the back, like your checkbook, that yellow card that's in the back, and sure, every one of us filled it out. So I would like to use your platform right now to reach out to all my previous veteran friends that know what I'm talking about. This was mid-Missouri. Call in, either call in on the hotline on Infowars.com, leave your name, your number. That's how we're going to get this out, is to get enough veterans to come forward and say, hey, we've been probed 10, 20 years ago for this very thing.
I'm going to hold you over. This is so important. I'm going to hold you over, because we got plenty of time this hour, and we're going to get to everybody else that's patiently holding as well. But, sir, see, this is how we're all compartmentalized. That actually came out in the news then that that was happening. And then a 29 Palms professor, a teacher, put out a mock one so he could put it out public and not break the law. He put a copy out but called it his own survey to see if they would do it. And he said that. I've interviewed him. Like, we should get him back on. I forget that gentleman's name. But the point is that this has been going on for a long, long time. And that's the good news, is they tried this in the mid-90s under Clinton, and now they're trying it again. The problem is they've made some headway in 20 years or 18 years on this. I'm going to come right back to you, Jason. Don't hang up. I guess you're a police officer now out of the Army. We're going to talk to you and get this info. But I am aware of that. The special report is 16 minutes long. It's up on Infowars.com. But I'm going to have it reposted under a new headline to get even more attention. It's Emergency Alert, Soldiers Warn of Coming Gun Confiscation. That's the special report from the Nightly News last night with myself, Rob Dew, and many others, with the whistleblowers and the documents of the mass gun confiscation plan. I'm going to have this reposted to Infowars.com, but really the headline should read, Obama prepares military for nationwide gun confiscation, or Obama readies military for nationwide gun confiscation, and then we will tweet that out once it's on Infowars.com. Because for military that's only gotten part of this, this is not all of it. It'd be hundreds of documents, but there's a good 15 news articles and documents in there so that they can see the informational and then see it for themselves, and it's not just me up here saying all of this, so that they can then add pieces to the puzzle as well. But this is not even pieces to a puzzle now. Now, let's go back. I'm going to shut up for the rest of the segment and let Jason, who's a police officer in Missouri, he was talking about in 95 getting these cards. We found the 29 Palms survey from 1994. Let's put that on screen while he talks, dealing with gun confiscation. And the last question asking if they would indeed do that, the combat arms survey. But that was actually 1994, May 10th. But let's go ahead now and go back to our guest and go ahead and finish. So you made your first point about that. Go ahead and make your other points.
Okay. Well, like I said, I've got several points that I've got to get off to you because it's been so hard to get onto your show. Second point is I woke up to your show specifically after the second election. So I guess my question would be, at what point, why was the big push for the states to secede from the union? That's how I discovered you. All of a sudden, after the second election, maybe I was just asleep. I always knew there was a certain level of tyranny since 88, since Bush Sr. made that comment. My brother's been preaching to me, do the New World Order, but you never saw anything. But I was lackadaisical, which I think most of the country has been, even being a veteran. Nothing ever really threatens us. And I think that's one of the reasons we're in the situation we're in now. So I do have one quick question to educate me as to what pushed you and Ron Paul to push the state seceding from the union. That's when I woke up.
Well, when I said secede, it's in the Declaration of Independence. It's not our right, it's our duty that when the governments become destructive of our basic liberties, that it's our job to create a new government. Well, I like the old republic. It's obviously the best system out there. Most historians agree. And so I was saying, let's not secede to end America. Let's secede to have the states pull back, declare the Washington FedGov illegitimate and occupied and captured to then reestablish the republic. And so that was the plan I developed that a lot of constitutional scholars, advisors to Congress, like Dr. Edwin Vieira and countless others, Lou Rockwell, many others that concurred. They said, no, your plan was actually talked about by Thomas Jefferson because they had problems then as well. And said, let's just abolish this again and do it again. Because, you know, it's like when something's really bad, sometimes you got to tear down a house if it's rotten and use the same blueprint that made it so good. But do you see my point there?
Yeah, exactly. I agreed with you. I just didn't understand because I hadn't been paying attention. And that was my question. If I could have high-fived you, I would be like, good job, brother. Actually, I texted you a bunch. I was for two months, my wife can tell you, I was steeped in following you and just trying to catch up. I was so far behind the eight ball. Keep in mind, I'm a police officer, I'm a veteran, and I was behind the eight ball. I was asleep at the wheel. So at the point that I woke up, right after the second election, I went on to YouTube, and it was just, to use your phrase that you've coined, it was unbelievable. I'm like, why are we not seeing this stuff on Fox News? Well, then I'm educated to the point they're all bought off. It's too late for that. So coming through the timeline, how I was just 24 hours a day, I was just living this, trying to learn as much as I could from you because you were the primary one.
And by the way, that's a normal response, too. When I found out about this stuff, I've been on the air a couple of years. I was more like a mainline libertarian. And then all of a sudden I had police and military giving me all this info and people thought I was crazy, but I had all the documents and I witnessed it. We're almost out of time. We're going to come back with more calls, but tell me real fast, are there any other points you wanted to make?
All right. So right after that, I started telling everybody that I could. I had an opportunity to speak with the sitting Missouri State Senator.
We got to stop again. I'm sorry. Stay there because that's only a six-minute segment. 18-minute segment coming up. We'll finish up with you in a couple minutes, Jason. Then we'll go to William, who's been holding for a while, Lindsay, Sid, Truth Raider, and everybody else. We're going to get to everybody as fast as I can. We come back, but this is important. Let him make his other points real quick. Then I got a whole plethora of other important news that we're going to be covering as well. I'm going to race through your calls and cover a ton of news, just the headlines I haven't gotten to yet, a bunch of new breaking news as well. Just remember, they're not just training to confiscate the firearms and admitting it. They're telling troops you can't give money to a Tea Party group. And that's totally illegal. That's like the mafia. That's racketeering to tell people what they can and can't do in their own lives. That's legal. And we're going to court-martial you if you're an evangelical Christian or give money to it. That's Fox News reporting that. And I already knew about this from sources, and it had been some of it in the news earlier this year. But it's just, I can't even believe how criminal the people are that run this government. And we cannot sit there and follow their orders. So real fast, Jason in Missouri, police officer, former Army, dropping the bombshell. Go over your points, but I got to ask you briefly, because this is what I've been told by others, and we know they're doing it now. I mean, it's on record. They're training for it and gun confiscation. We had the Navy SEAL on 2 days ago covering it. But when you're in there being asked, will you fire on American citizens to then gauge what unit you can be stuck in? Because if you say yes, you get promoted, obviously. It's total evil. What were people saying after you guys walked out of the gymnasium being asked if you would fire on American citizens or confiscate their guns?
You know, I thought about that because I figured you might ask me that or another caller might ask that. And honestly, it's been so long ago, I don't remember. However, I do remember everybody felt very uneasy, which one of the last points that I'm going to make, this has happened again with somebody that I know who's in the Navy, and I'll tell you his response to his dad. So I can get off here so the next guy can call. Just let me finish my point. I was speaking with a Missouri State Senator who I had met through my other job, and I said, sir, what's going on in Washington? I was told he was a senator. He said, oh, no, I'm a state Missouri State Senator. He said, but I know what you mean. I was like, man. And I told him about you, and I told him about what I learned. He confirmed everything about you and Agenda 21. He said, it is so bad. He said that he was thinking about getting out, and I said, well, why? We need good people like you in there. He looked me straight in the eyes, Alex, and this is exactly what he said, and I quote, he said, I will have nothing to do with what is fixing to befall the American people. And my stomach come up in my throat. His wife is to his left. She's crying, and I said, have I done something? She said, no. She said, I fought this for years. I thought he was just nuts about this stuff. But she said, what I have learned being a senator's wife, she said, I know that it's 100% fact. He said, immediately start stockpiling guns, water, food, and ammo. He said, that's all I can tell you. I said, well, what do we do? What do we, you know, is there something we can do at the state level? He said, I'm going to inform you what I know. He said, the Missouri State Senate had already, at that point, now this was last, the week of Christmas last year. This is prior to any of the shooting. He said, the Missouri State Senate had already voted to secede from the union, but our governor said, not yet. I said, well, what are we waiting for? He said, well, he said, that's a good question. He said, but there is a plan in place to remove him from power if need be. He said, I cannot discuss anything further. I've been trying to call into the show for months to let you know this.
Well, no, so, I know this stuff's all going on. I mean, even David Dewhurst, his former top CIA and establishment, says the government's pure evil, has lost credibility, and has to be removed because they're going to wreck. It's going to be a red takeover. Again, it's foreign banks doing it, but they're going to use a red takeover agenda. And they're really planning it. And the Civil War is, because enough cops and military will follow the orders to start a civil war. And enough citizens are going to end up going, who are just waiting and are fed up. It's going to be a disaster. And then the commies are going to just wait while we kill each other and then come in later. And then the foreign banks have set this all up. And that's basically what people are talking about. And there's the Atlantic Wire. Who knew? Secession again on the agenda in Missouri. It basically breaks down what you were just talking about from last year. So I appreciate your call, sir. Yes. That's why at that time I called for the second American Revolution in the info war to have the states pull out. The feds will say it's illegitimate. We counter, you're not even a federal government. Because you are supposed to have the feds keep the states in check. The states keep the feds in check. Balance of power, just like two sides of Congress, just like the judiciary, the legislative, the executive, the fourth estate, the media, the fifth estate, the juries. I mean, you're supposed to have all these checks and balances, or you always, if you have one power structure, you could have a good king or a good leader. They're going to die. People, the bad guys are going to kill them in a palace coup to put bad guys in. That's why you almost always get bad guys with a centralized system. They've had a few dozen good kings, philosopher kings, in world history, the last 6,000 recorded years of history. And you do get incredible leaps forward during those periods. Not that a philosopher king's the way to go, but compared to the horrible corrupt systems they had of corrupt royal families and their courts, if you ever got a king who actually wanted to empower people and really inform people and really build things and really, even if it was for their own arrogant reasons, you would get incredible civilizations out of that. Well, a free society, a free market society, will create so much wealth. The problem is you then become decadent. So how do you gauge that to be a free market society that's incredibly rich, but then the corruption sets in? And so that's why we pull out now, if the states all pulled out and said, New World Order captured us, foreign banks captured us, we're going to do like Iceland did, we're going to forget all this foreign debt, communist Chinese, you know, you actually are owed $2 trillion, we will pay you that back. That's nothing with the faith and credit of the U.S. if we don't let them wreck us. They want to wreck us so bad, shutting off the power plants, shutting off the infrastructure, shutting off the jobs, bringing in the giant third world populations to be client state groups. They want to blow our engine out so they can capture us. And basically, if we were a ship, use the corny Star Wars analogy, you got the Star Destroyer chasing the counselor ship, and they're shooting at each other, and they want to blow the engine so they can suck us up. I mean, but America is big. I mean, it's like trying to eat an elephant. And so they got a problem. And now they're already collapsing the world system to bring in the world government, but everybody's awake to them who matters. And so it's this Mexican standoff that I talked about earlier, where we're both pointing guns at each other, basically. And we need to convince people out there that the rights... Look, even if we were going to lose, ladies and gentlemen, even if we were going to lose, we would have to say no to this because it's so horrible what the end game of it is. I said I'd go to your calls. William, who's police, thank you for holding, from Tennessee. William, what is your take on all this?
Yes, sir. I had some just different information. Like your last caller, I've been trying to get on for a little while. I assist in the grant writing at my department, and we've got a COPS grant, which is an acronym for Community-Oriented Policing. And the government has put out basically like a survey, and for us to keep the grant and to be eligible to get more federal assistance, we're supposed to complete these surveys. We're supposed to go door-to-door, and we're asking a lot of outlandish questions that have caused me great alarm.
Yeah, basically, it's a knock and talk to get the federal money, which then conditions the public and the police to have non-traditional police activities. You're now going to be given a political police officer Soviet Commissar job. This is Commissar training. It's going on nationwide. Tell folks about it.
It's a bunch of just random questions about how many people are in your household, how many people have medical conditions. Do you have any firearms? And then there's some standard questions about, you know, gross income. And this is all done on a voluntary, I'm sorry, I just got cut off.
No, you're there. You're there.
It's done on a voluntary, you know, basis, but it's, we're intimidating to the public. And it's just the way things have gone over the last couple of years. And it's horrible, and it's definitely something that I didn't know if we're like being a test market or this is happening nationwide. Have you heard anything else about this?
Yes, sir. They call it knock and talk under federal grants that started about 15 years ago, but police departments just started refusing the money because they did it in Dallas, they did it in Austin, they did it all over Texas, where they would come and knock and say, we'd like to inspect your guns and see if they're safe. In Boston and in New York, they actually forced their way in. They've got units of police that'll do that to go, I don't care. I want to see if there's guns to get the federal money. And they put that on the news. You can pull up Knock and Talk in Boston. You can actually find that on YouTube. And it shows the families being basically forcing their way in. Kind of like federal grants. If the police department wants the federal grant, they've got to set up a checkpoint. That's not a checkpoint, but it really is. To just ask if you want to give some DNA. And then people get so scared they do it. And again, it's priming the pump. Just like if you're about to start a lawnmower and you hit the button a couple points to prime it with gas. So, they slipped that gun question in there. And really, they're probing the departments to see if you comply. They're probing the officers to see if you can comply. They're conditioning you to do things you don't like. We're all being socially engineered. We're all being hammered. And yes, it's going on under different guises. So Knock and Talk was so unpopular. Starting 3 years ago in select areas, they started having the police go out and call it community survey assistance in the documents I saw. I think it was out of Missouri, speaking of Missouri. And they go to the door and then they say, oh, we just got a few questions for you, ma'am, as a supplement to the census and community policing. And again, real community policing is where the cops got a beat. Everybody knows him. You know, the cop sits there and throws the football with you in the front yard where he doesn't have a call, like, you know, folks growing up 50, 60 years ago. This is the opposite of that. This is spy policing. This is interrogation policing. This is not community policing.
I have a copy of that form if there's a way I can get it to you guys, if you'd like it for your records.
Yes, sir. CC it to showtips at Infowars.com, and I'm going to put you on hold here for a moment, and I'm going to give you one of the emails that isn't that doesn't get thousands a day to make sure we don't lose it. And obviously, it's not wrong for you to show me that form, but still they might mess with you. I would advise you, because it'll just give the NSA more trouble, to pay with cash from someplace and scan it there and send it to us, or use your... I don't want to sit there. I mean, you should be able to send me that. Just make the decision whether you want them to know or not, because let me just tell everybody something right now. They watch everything that comes in here. I mean, it's unbelievable. They follow me around when I leave here. It's a lot of... So I live like a little... I'm not even worried about it, whatever. But the point is that, yes, please send me that. Showtips at Infowars.com, and then I'm going to put you on hold, and then I'm going to tell John Harmon, cover my mouth here, which email to send that to. So thank you very much. Don't hang up, William. I'm going to go on hold here. Okay, fantastic. I just gave, in fact, John already knew which email to send it to, and send that to me. I mean, if I was a cop, I wouldn't care. If they're going to mess with you or go to your department, And try to, you know, put you on a list because you sent us their little federal thing. There's nothing wrong. It's not a secret document. I'm just saying, obviously, the cop knows that. But just I want to remind people. Like when somebody comes to work here, I tell them up front, you might end up getting put in a gulag down the road if we lose this thing. So I'm not kidding. So just know. And if they ever think they can intimidate you, they will try. So, and everybody just commits. I mean, it's surprising how much courage the average person has when they know they're in the right. But they need a community of people to stand together. And that's why police chiefs are becoming little federal minions more and more, because they should stand behind officers just to be good people. I mean, come on. This is not rocket science to do this kind of stuff. So, yes. Also, they're using those databases to index them with the census and to see how you answered the forms. It's kind of like companies will give you a psychological test a couple times, you know, to see how you answer different times, to try to see what type of person you are. I mean, there's just a lot of guinea pig stuff going on. Notice government, it's all secret. And if you want to ask the government a question, you're evil, but then it wants to know everything you're doing. That's backwards. We should know what the government's doing. They shouldn't know what we're doing until we go out and do something wrong. And until we become a known perpetrator. Then the due process, you know, starts to go out the window a little bit because you're a known quantity. Well, these governments are known quantities, ladies and gentlemen. These governments are out of control, not just ours, every other one. It's like a person. You will die. Governments will get taken over and become corrupt. I'm surprised how long ours has survived. It's had a lot of problems. It's been corrupt. But, I mean, this is a takeover. This isn't the American establishment doing this. This is the end of this republic. We're going to break. We're going to talk to Leslie when we come back. Says, survey about bomb threats. Yeah, they're doing those everywhere to create a climate of fear. We're going to go to Truth Raider and then the others. I'll get to everybody that's on the board now, but no more calls after that. Kurt, Sid, Lindsay, Jason, and Truth Raider. I haven't plugged anything all day here on air. We're 2 hours, 48 minutes into transmission. I am self-funded by viewers and listeners like you. And we're able to have the news division, the filmmaking division, the magazine, the news sites. We're reaching more people every day. We've been able to capitalize ourselves from losing money to being able to make back some of the deficit and be able to continue expanding thanks to some of the product rollouts of the new hidden dash cam system that looks like a rearview mirror that we have at the lowest price anywhere at InfoWarsStore.com. The Pro One water filters and Pro Pure, lowest price, 10% off, promo code WATER. We are sold out until at least 2 weeks from now, but it should be here in 2 weeks. It's being manufactured right now. The nascent iodine that everybody's been trying and says we've never seen anything like it. Well, that's because I found that it was very, very special the way it's done. It's patented, and it really is amazing. It's Survival Shield, known as a fluoride detox. InfoWarsLife.com or InfoWarsStore.com, you'll find it that way as well. But we do have Modafylon in stock at the lowest price. The lowest price we're allowed to sell it at by the producer of it. It's the clean Southern Hemisphere brown seaweed that has the wide spectrum natural iodine, nascent iodine, because they absorb it that way. So it's in the metabolized form in there and is also very, very dynamic and very, very powerful. And some people can't handle the, you know, check with your physician first, the detoxing effects of the regular superpowered nascent iodine. So the Modafylon's the way to go. It's not as powerful, but it is powerful. We have that at InfoWarsStore.com. And lastly, I've been taking both of these, 1 week on, 1 week off. Ancient Legacy by InfoWarsHealth.com and Longevity is a whole spectrum of the clean seaweeds and other ocean life. Ocean's Gold, Ancient Legacy, Ocean's Gold, 60 tablets available at InfoWarsHealth.com. That's the Longevity division. You can sign up and get 10% off, or you can sign up and get free shipping when you sign up there at InfoWarsHealth.com for auto ship. You can pay $10 and then get big discounts. So InfoWarsHealth.com or InfoWarsTeam.com if you want to be a distributor. InfoWarsTeam.com, InfoWarsHealth.com, and the nascent iodine at InfoWarsLife.com. There's been a Tennessee naval base in lockdown after shooting. We'll see what's happening with that straight ahead. Looks like more of their wind-up toys. Tennessee Naval Base in lockdown after shooting. The Naval Base in Millington, Tennessee is on lockdown after shooting, local media reported. Navy officials confirmed that the incident was near the Naval Support Activity in Millington. NBC station WMCTV in Memphis, citing city officials, reported that at least two people had been shot near the base, and they were both reportedly in non-critical condition. Well, that's good news then. I hope nobody dies. Also, NSA monitoring calls of 35 world leaders after U.S. official handed over contacts. I mean, of course they're spying on foreign leaders. That's what they're supposed to be spying on, not us. I mean, governments all spy on each other. You don't spy on gun owners and Christians and the Associated Press, you criminal government. So, but this is all becoming a big giant scandal. And by the way, all those governments are spying as well. And I'm not endorsing all of this. The point is espionage always goes on. But the globalists run our government, and they're engaged in espionage against American companies and individuals and people that aren't part of the globalist combine. Do you understand that? It isn't America doing this. It's globalists using America's NSA to run all these scams everywhere and to get dirt on people, including Congress. And that's come out. MI6 has been caught spying on the parliament to blackmail people. I mean, what do you think goes on with shadow government? It's out of control. Let's go to Leslie in North Carolina. You're on the air. Thanks for calling.
Hey, Alex.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, I was calling about two issues. One is that my girlfriend, she called for an appointment to the doctor, and they asked her about her religion preference.
Yeah, they're not supposed to do that under political correctness, but instead they do it now for everything.
They done that, and she went to the doctor and had her waiting over an hour for that, and it took a week to get a prescription that she called for this day she did an appointment. And my grandmother informed me that I talked to her back in the 70s. They used to do that when she called for her appointment. And she also been asked that when she called for her last doctor's appointment.
Well, that's right. They're doing all sorts of stuff. And then if you are a Christian, we found they discriminate against you. These people are anti-Christian. I mean, at the end of the day, driving this is an evil agenda. And they want to extinguish real Christianity. They want to extinguish the family and real manhood and motherhood. And they've done a really good job of it. And now they're telling parents they can't make their children their own lunch under federal guidelines. And I told you that was the case in Chicago. Now it's in Virginia. Now it's in Colorado. And they tell the parents, you will not pack their lunch. The parents bow down and do it. And if you go to a PTA meeting and complain, cops arrest you. We've shown those videos. I don't like my daughter being taught 2 plus 2 equals 5. Here is the folder. This is crazy. Cop comes up, grabs the guy, you're going to jail.
They also said that on the news, the local news, that about the schools want about using local farms and stuff about for school lunches.
Well, you're saying they aren't using local farms?
Yeah, there's some of them are that they want to use local farm, but
well, they're supposed to be independent school districts, and if people on PTA and all this had any brains, that you should try to get your food locally, and they should absolutely. God bless you. Good to hear from you. We just got loaded phone lines as usual. I want to try to get to all these people. We're about to go to break. Truth Raider and Sid and Kurt. I don't know about. I want to go to Jason too. I've got so much to do after the show, folks. I go into too much overdrive. Truth Raider, real fast, tell us what's going on.
Hey, Alex, still hanging in there. I want to tell you about a great patriot and a whistleblower by the name of Phil Schneider. You need to look him up on YouTube.
I think I've had him on
Phil
before.
Schneider.
Yep.
Great guy. They offed him in January of 96.
But I had somebody on about him a long time ago, but I'll look that up. Thank you. We'll be right back in overdrive. Take more of your calls. Have breaking news. All right, let's talk to Sid in Alaska, north to Alaska. You're on the air, sir. Welcome.
Hi, Alex.
Hey, buddy.
Nice to talk to you. I want to thank you for, back in 2010, you played my video someone made of me at the Alaska State Fair with the Impeach Obama sign.
I don't remember it, but I'm sure I did.
It was titled, it's on YouTube, it's titled LaRouche Supporter Assaulted by Alaska State Fair.
Oh, Security. I do remember that now, yes.
So I've been out on the corner here in Palmer, Alaska, with the same sign going after Obama. I just wanted to make one point.
Yes, sir.
That Americans, we have an epidemic of cowardice in this country, and people are acting like Obama's going to be out of there any time. Well, they need to realize that he's going to be in there until 2017 if we don't impeach him. And I also want to let your listeners, especially here in Alaska, know that I'm running against Dirt Baggage for Senate next year, Mark Baggage. And I'm just going to see if you had any response to that about Obama being in there until 2017.
Well, you know, he's a puppet that's kind of lived out his usefulness, I think, for the globalists politically, but who knows? Anything's possible now. I mean, these public schools under federal command say you can't pack your kids' lunches now. It's not just, it's going nationwide. I mean, there's almost nothing we won't bend over for. And so who knows? I appreciate your call. Let's talk to Kurt. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Hey, Alex, Kurt here. How you doing?
Great, brother.
Hey, man, I was just listening to your show yesterday, and you had a caller that was, you know, talking to you about how they planned on pulling this whole thing off. Well, I think I might have a possible answer for that guy and for your audience. Basically, it dawned on me that they've been running demographs and questionnaires through our military, and I have a sneaking suspicion that our ranks are pro-American, patriotic people just like us, and they're not mindless zombies. So what I think they might do is create a problem overseas, i.e. Syria or any of those things, and they will move all of our troops over there to fight this bullshit war. Ooh, sorry. Sorry, I accidentally cussed. But once the troops are overseas and gone, then they'll bring in their foreign mercenaries and the mop-up crew to do all the dirty work. What do
I
you
appreciate your call. No, I mean, that's always been the plan. The troops that say they won't foreign Americans are loaded up with a huge vaccine regimen to be sent to the most hellish place in the world. And those that say, I want to, you know, take guns, I hate John Wayne, I hate George Washington, on record, they end up being your police chief. I mean, that's how they work. They're a bunch of traitors, and they sit there getting, and now they think they've amassed enough of these guys to do this, but I don't think that's the case. And it's just, we're living in a science fiction movie. I constantly almost pinch myself and like go, this really happening? I've really got the Associated Press saying Pentagon may court-martial soldiers who share Christian faith. Soldiers to be court-martialed if they give money to the Tea Party. I mean, what? I mean, it's just like, yeah, they're using the IRS on people that have done nothing wrong. It's incredible. Thank you for the call. Let's talk to Jason in FEMA Region 6. Go ahead. Or 10,
hey,
excuse me.
Alex, give me just a few minutes to get through this really quick, not even minutes. Number one, born and raised Mennonite. Number two, born again atheist. I don't have any disposition against any religion. Number three, if you are active duty military, you will keep your mouth shut on this litmus test. You will go along with these people, and you will find out who your brothers in arms are. And you will rise up against these motherfuckers. Pardon me.
I let him go. These people think it's cute if they cuss, because then it still goes out on the video streams. But then you just get cut out on the AM and FM station, so 95% of the audience never hears you. I mean, it's just, like, totally ridiculous. But I understand you're angry about stuff. But we'll be back on the Nightly News tonight. Some really special info, 7 o'clock Central.